is magnified, and the butterflies feel like 747.
Yeah, 747s and a big load in your gut because you can't afford to make mistakes. So there's no telling what we'll see tonight. We may see a starter come out of the bullpen who's not used to that role, but the team that forces the mistakes is the one that's going to win. The other night we saw Rice throwing the ball around the ballpark. They definitely can't afford to do that tonight.
Oklahoma State slugger Lamont Matthews leads the nation with 105 RBIs, but in his first College World Series game, he was called out on strikes three times, once with the bases loaded. Tough start.
Well, a very tough start. They pitched him great. Now, he has to forget the past and be able to be strong enough to come back. One of his problems was they pitched him so well, they moved the ball in and out, and then he was abused with the breaking pitch that was up. And then this pitch right here, though, the strikeout, the ball away, he felt like he got pitches that were out of the zone. When you have a problem like that, you eliminate the umpire. You can't allow him to affect your approach at the plate.
The pressure is on. Oklahoma State and Rice. One will survive to see tomorrow. The other goes home. We'll have the starting lineups and the opening pitch when we come back to Rosenblatt in Omaha, Nebraska.
There's a dream in every club. There's a wish on every ball. And once again, you'll make that name back.
At Circuit City, we have everything you need for your computer.
From software and hardware, printers, high-speed modems, memory, or you can design your own system.
Right now at Circuit City, save $195 on this eMachines computer with 15-inch monitor and Canon Bubble Jet color printer, just $549.99 after rebates. And save $40 on a Microsoft Office 2000 standard upgrade, just $189.99 after rebate. Don't miss the savings right now at Circuit City.
Sometimes you have to make a choice. You can throw in the towel, or you can use it to wipe the sweat off your face.
What a shot. How'd you do it?
With the Elf, there's nothing to it. The Elf 370Z is full of surprises, like a three-time zoom and three picture sizes. Have you seen all the Elves?
What a shot. From Canon.
Places I started singing in down here in South Texas got the ladies in by dropping the cover charge. Well, Tractor Supply Company's done that one better. They put in things women shop for every day. Jeans, clothing, horse and pet supplies, seed, garden tools, riding tractors, and a lot more. So ladies, don't be bashful about that word tractor, because there's a lot in those Tractor Supply Company stores for you too. Oh, and no cover charge either.
ESPN2's presentation of the NCAA College World Series is brought to you by Canon. So advanced, it's simple. And by Tractor Supply. Whether you have 1 acre or 1,000, Tractor Supply will help you get the job done.
Almost set to go here at the College World Series in Omaha, Nebraska. As twilight is approaching, Tom Holliday, in his third year as the head coach at Oklahoma State, the longtime assistant under the departed Gary Ward. Here is the way his club will line up this evening in an elimination game. Batting first and playing left field, Carlos Gotro. Second base, Kevin Lucas. The third hitter is Billy Gasparino. He plays shortstop. Josh Holliday, the coach's son, the cleanup man at third base. The nation's RBI leader, Lamont Matthews, hitting fifth and playing right. Jay McCullough, the first baseman, hitting sixth. Chris Becerra is the designated hitter today. Did not play in the first game. Toby Rhodes will start in center field. They platoon that spot. And Ryan Buddy, the catcher, will bat ninth.
Well, they had their struggles in game one, Mike, and that was one of the reasons they ended up getting beat. This has been a very productive team. They got shut down by good pitching. Struggled quite a bit as a group, but this game, you just got to regroup. You got to throw everything out and go ahead and go do it.
And pitching, even with the aluminum bat in a smaller ballpark, will still get it done, won't it?
Absolutely. We look at Kenny Baugh tonight, the starter for Rice. Rice, one of the nation's top pitching staffs. This young man's going to remind you a lot of Stanford's Jason Young. Very similar delivery. They both step across their body and very awkward for a right-handed hitter to hit. Good fastball, slider. It's going to be tough.
Maybe the most critical statistic for the Rice Owls, he is 4-0 following a loss. this year, and they cannot afford another. Carlos Gautreau, a junior from Abbeville, Louisiana, steps in at 3:45 against Kenny Baugh. And we're underway. Home plate umpire Rich Fetchett. And we'll establish that strike zone early. That was a little high, 2-0.
See that motion right there, Mike? That's what I was talking about comparing him to Young, Stanford's Young, that is. He steps across his body and then throws back across his body. So it's a tough pitch, a tough angle. I'm surprised he throws as hard as he does because he really doesn't take advantage of his whole body positioning.
Shadows will be a problem for a couple of innings. 3-0 to Gautreau, and he pours a fastball in there for 3-1. Now, these are the kind of things you have pitching coaches that try to work on. Sometimes you don't want to mess with a guy's natural motion. Wrapped right back up the middle for a base hit for Gautreau. Leads off the game with a sharp single.
Nice piece of hitting by Gautreau. Now, the other night, Oklahoma State was not very aggressive. And they usually are a very aggressive team. Right here, he gets in a 3-1 count, gets a fastball, and drives it right back up the middle. I don't care how hard you throw, you get behind hitters 3-1, and they know what's coming. They're going to be able to turn on it.
Gautreau does not have a green light, although he has speed. And Kevin Lucas, the senior second baseman, stands in, hitting 345 on the year. Coaches say he's the best bunter they ever saw, not just had, but saw.
Well, Mike, the other thing he does so well is he pushes the ball towards second base. Now, Rice, second baseman, is playing really close to the bag, and he was looking to push it right through this area right here is where you want to push, in between the lines. You want to go that area. Now, when the second baseman is positioned close to second base, that still allows you the opportunity to go there. A lot of coaches don't like you to push it with the runner on first, but it's a good play if you can execute like this young man. And there it is.
Beautiful. Pitcher getting over. Not in time. Harold, he executed it exactly the way you said he should. He's done it so many times this year.
Well, he's had 30 bunt hits, and they said he likes to push the ball to the right side. Now, the key is once you get it past the pitcher, it's a foot race. Even though Kenny's a great athlete, you force the second baseman to have to make the flip. And Kevin Lucas can get down the line. And that was a great play. Even though it was a close play, and Wayne Graham's going to come out and argue the fact that he felt like his pitcher still beat him to the bag. I didn't see the replay real clear, Mike.
From the replay, it looked to me like Kenny Baugh was there maybe a half a step.
Oh, okay.
Before the runner. I thought they had.
We'll know tomorrow when we look at the film, won't we?
Now, Wayne, we've already looked at our film. We already know.
Well, Rice the other day was not real happy with the umpire, and they had some tough calls on them that night.
Didn't they ever?
And now the first inning, he didn't waste any time popping out of the dugout tonight.
No, he's got to defend his ball club and defend his situation. First two runners reach, a single back up the middle and a bunt single for Billy Gasparino, the senior from Tampa, Florida. And he squares around to bunt. Gasparino, a 369 hitter, second best on the club. He's 1-for-5 in the College World Series so far. And some big power numbers, 24 homers, 91 runs batted in. Both of those are second on the team. They lead virtually everybody else in the country, but those are second here. Fastball just low. Kenny Baugh trying to get out of a first inning jam. He's fallen behind the number three hitter, Billy Gasparino, 2-0. Strike call. The outfield is around to the left and deep, even though the wind is blowing 15 to 20 miles an hour straight across the field to right.
Little action play here.
Breaking ball hangs high as he squared the bunt again.
You know, I'm watching the runner at second base. Goutreau, and whenever he stands in the baseline, they put on a bunt. He stands back in the baseline. They're letting the guy swing away. Right now, the way he's walking off, he's not going anywhere. They're going to be swinging the bat.
Well, that's a great pickup, Harold.
A lot of times, base runners will tell you the situation in the game. If you're observant and you pay attention, they'll tell you what's going to happen by their leads. He gets a bigger lead right here, 3-2. He'll be telling you, you know what, we're running on this pitch. Right there from where he's at, he's not stealing third.
Here's the 3-2. Walked him. Kenny Baugh digging himself a big hole right here. The first three men reach base for Josh Halladay, the senior third baseman who told all the major league clubs last year, don't bother to draft me. I am coming back. My dad is the head coach. I love my teammates. Going to find a way to get to Omaha, and boy, he's done it.
Well, Mike, let's go back to game one. First inning, they had the bases loaded then, too. And they did not deliver.
Got to have the timely hits. And now the wind is blowing in some, and right now more to right than it is in, and the flags just shifted a little more in. 2-0, power hitter, left-hander against righty. You're sitting there on dead heat, aren't you?
You're licking your chops. Now I think the butterflies are on the pitcher's mound right now, because you don't want to come inside to this young man. You're down 4-0 if he gets one in the air.
Fifteen home runs on the year for Halladay. 1-for-3 in the College World Series. Fastball on the corner. It's a nice pitch from Kenny Baugh.
Absolutely. You took the words right out of my mouth. Great location. He went with the fastball away. Well aware of the situation now of where he needs to put that pitch.
Tirana and Nichols already up in the bullpen. Took something off and missed outside. It's 3-1.
Well, you can't afford to wait around. You're going to go to your pen early. You can't let the game get out of hand. This is it. You lose, you're gone.
Ace of your staff or not. Fastball swings at a 3-1 pitch and pops it back on the roof. The last thing Wayne Graham wanted to see. Fastball hammered outside, first foul. Ow.
Well, you were going to say the last thing Wayne Graham wanted to see was a bases loaded situation in the first. Is that what you were going to say?
Absolutely.
See, I've been doing all these games with you. I can even, I'm a step with you now.
Another payoff pitch on the way.
Oh,
struck him out. Takes it off, pulls the string on. What a pitch.
Wow. He hasn't shown a changeup the whole inning and all the trouble he's been in. Look at this change of pace. And it's a tough pitch to pick up in the shadows. Probably tougher than anything else. The ball's going to go from light into the dark. And he gives you great arm action with it. Tremendous pitch.
Well, you got to have some guts to throw a changeup on 3-2, top of the first, bases loaded. You haven't gotten anybody out yet.
Whew.
Now here's Lamont Matthews, 105 RBIs, 30 home runs this year. He was caught looking three times in the opening game against Alabama. He'd love to make up for it. And right now, this is the place Oklahoma State wants to see him do it. Looked like he took something off again.
Another change of pace.
Now, last time down at third, only 90 feet away. Kevin Lucas at second, and Gasparino, who walked, is down at first. 1-1 to Matthew. Missed outside.
I was going to say, the last time Matthews had the bases loaded in that first game we were talking about, he didn't get a swing. You know, they painted the pitches on him so well, he didn't even take a strike.
Four grannies this year. This would obviously be the biggest one. Inside corner, 2-2.
And Kenny Ball doing a nice job of mixing them up, doing the changeup right there, threw a little cutter in on his hands.
This may be bigger for Oklahoma State than it is for Rice if they don't score here. Struck him out. The nation's RBI leader is 0 for 4 in the College World Series. He has fanned each time.
This was a tremendous pitch sequence. Now watch here. He goes with the little something off speed inside. The change of pace away. Fastball out to show him the pitch. Little cutter on the inside half. And then right here, inside the shadows, in and out, another changeup. And Mike, as this inning progresses, his changeup's better than I thought it was.
It's a sweetheart right now. There's a breaking ball, drops low and outside. This is Jay McCullough, senior from Frederick, Oklahoma. First three men reach, and then Baugh comes back to strike out the 4-5 men, Holiday and Matthews. Strike called. He evens the count against Jay McCullough, who's a 3-12 hitter. So he has weathered the beginning and the middle of the storm. Can he weather the end of it?
Well, this is really a sign of concentration for Kenny Ball right here.
Looped foul, and it'll drop harmlessly down the right field line. It is 1-2.
What I mean by that, Mike, is it was in the heart of the lineup. You can't let up. You have no mental lapses at all, or else you're in trouble. He got through Holiday, pitched Matthews tough, and he's got a 1-2 count now.
He's not only in trouble, he's out of the ballgame. I mean, the bullpen is up with nobody out in the first, and they're warming in a hurry. He gets two in a row on K's, trying to do the same with McCullough. Grounded towards short. Thames to 4-6 second. They leave the bases loaded, and that's got to be the most depressing thing that could have happened to Oklahoma State, and what a huge lift for the Owls of Rice. End of a half inning. And it's nothing, nothing. Dave Ryan is with us. He has been. He and Harold Reynolds have been working much harder than Gary Miller and I. We're on semi-permanent vacation out here. Dave, what's happening?
Mike, thanks a lot. We're having a good time down here, though. You know, Rice shortstop Damon Thames says his team will not be intimidated by facing an elimination game here tonight. He told his teammates before the game, don't play scared. Be aggressive at the plate and in the field as well. He said, hey, this has happened to us twice before. In the regional at Texas Tech, they won two games in Lubbock to stay alive. Then the super regional at home at the Astrodome had to beat Southwestern Louisiana in back-to-back games to face off elimination. Guys, they've been here before, and they will not back down tonight against Oklahoma State. They're not too scared.
All right, Dave, thanks very much. Let's take a look at the Rice Owls lineup. They have faced these situations before, as you pointed out. Charles Williams will lead it off at 366 and play left. Brett Smith is the second baseman. Damon Thames, the shortstop, hits third. The cleanup man is Will Ford. He'll play in right field. Justin Berg moves up to fifth as the DH. Jason Gray, the center fielder, is the number six hitter. Jacob Baker in seventh at first base. Zane Curry, the number eight hitter, the catcher. And Matt Fox, the third baseman, will bat ninth.
And here's the pitcher, Matt Smith, 9-5 this year. This is a big, strong left-hander. He's not your traditional lefty who's going to throw you a lot of change-ups that fade away. He is a power pitcher. You can look at 134 strikeouts, 43 walks, but the 134 strikeouts, 107 innings, that is impressive.
Yes, it is.
But he will throw, Mike. He'll throw you a fastball, a slider, and he'll throw a change also. But his best pitch is his fastball. He's going to use that to establish everything else.
They haven't gotten a win out of their starters since May 15th. Wayne Graham, the Rice coach, has to be breathing a little easier. Let's go back and show you his reaction in that first inning. The base is still loaded now with two out, though. Yes, sir. He didn't just dodge a bullet, and that's with a bad back, folks. He dodged a rocket launcher.
You have to stretch his back in between innings. He's so sore. And that, right there, I guess he did his own little exercise.
That's right. He won't mind a bit. It was really huge for him.
Man.
Matt Smith, who was a model of consistency until about a month ago, Tom Holliday says he really hopes he's on tonight the way he had been earlier in the year. Williams, a 366 hitter. He is 0 for 2 here in the series. Checked his swing and takes a call, strike two.
Well, you'll know early if Matt Smith is on his game or not. He's the type of pitcher that, as that will indicate that in the first two innings.
Ooh, that was close to take on 0-2.
It's a good-looking young man.
He's got some giddy up on it, doesn't he? Well, they say on the gun that he's 87 with a top of 92. But some guys look faster than others, and that looks faster.
Absolutely. He's got great mechanics.
Missed downstairs, 2-2. Williams steps out. Now, if you're Rice, you want to take advantage of the momentum they gained by getting out of that huge jam. And there's another fastball just burned on the inside part of the plate.
I tell you, the shadows are going to be tough today, early going. I don't think we'll see a whole lot of offense unless the pitchers give it up.
The Oklahoma State defense in the outfield, Gautreau in left, Toby Rhodes, who is a platoon center fielder, Lamont Matthews in right. Back out of play for Brett Smith, 0-1.
Well, the other day we talked about Ryan Buddy, the catcher, how important he is to this team. With a great rocket arm back there helping shut down the running game.
Just inside. You watch Smith throw like that. You know you got to run to the dugout and grab it back because you're going to have to swing it.
Indeed.
Ooh.
He's not just throwing straight fastballs either. That was a cutter in on the hands about 90. Nasty pitch. I don't know about that gun. That gun's saying 88, but I think my eyes are seeing that a little bit faster.
Oh! Well, I tell you, it gets up there in a hurry.
Well, when you're hitting in the shadows, you really want to get in a count where you know a fastball is coming. Then you can try to go ahead and gauge it. Other than that, it's awfully tough when they start getting in counts where you don't know if a fastball is coming in a 1-2 count or a 1-1 situation, or even 2-2 right now where he can still has the option to throw that slider.
Down and away. Runs the count to 3-2 on Brett Smith. Been good at drawing walks all year long and draws one here. Let's go back and take a look at the rest of the Oklahoma State Cowboy defense. Holiday, who moved from behind the plate down to third so that Buddy could play. Gasparino forced into a lot of throwing errors this year. Lucas at second, McCullough at first. Buddy behind the plate. He doesn't block balls all that well. Boy, he's got a major league arm. He can gun it.
He really does. Interesting, Gasparino and Lucas flip-flop positions this year also. One move from short to second, the other one from second to short.
Damon Thames stands in at 376 and singles to center. Smith around second on his way to third, and he'll make it easily. First and third with one out. So Thames didn't waste any time.
Well, there's certain ball players here at the World Series that I've been telling you, put a star on because you're going to see him again. And this is another guy, Damon Thames, college player of the year a year ago. Look at him go down and hit this fastball and drive it the other way. You take what the pitcher gives you. That's what happened in game one that the hitters did so well. Just stays behind the ball and drives it into right center field. And Matt Smith, with some great base running, ends up at second. Or Brett Smith, I should say. Ends up at third.
Will Ford comes in, 12 home runs, 73 RBIs on the year. He had a home run in his opening game here in Omaha. Leads the team in average and RBI.
Now, the other night, Mike, Rice tried to, when the hitter had two strikes, they tried to run a little third and first play, trying to get the runner first started to draw a throw, and then you want to steal that back in run. See if they do anything this inning.
So safety squeeze, apparently.
Yeah, it's interesting because you start the runner at third coming hard. He was going to bunt that ball down the third baseline. Now, lefty on lefty. Wayne Graham's thinking down there, hey, maybe I'll go ahead and use a bunt right here and just push a run in.
Not a bad idea. This will get the infielders on their toes, and Holiday sneaking in a little bit from third. 1-1 to Will Ford. Outside, 2-1. So Rice responding to the Oklahoma State rally, doing the same in their half of the first.
Well, what's interesting, Mike, now, with the left-handed pitcher, the runner on third can come down the line a little bit further because he's not going to pick him up. And you get usually you get about the distance the third baseman is from the base. That's your lead. But if you got a left-handed pitcher, it allows you to come down the line a little bit further, and that's why they're able to try to execute a safety bunt, safety squeeze.
Outside, 3-1.
Looked down at the third base coach, and Wayne Graham went, swing the bat. What are you thinking about? Well, coach, you gave me the bunt earlier. What do you think I'm thinking about?
3-1 to Ford. Going after a high fastball. They're so tempting and so hard to get around on.
Oh, that ball up in your eyes is the easiest pitch to see, but the toughest one to catch up to. 3-2, might see some action here.
See if Thames is going from first and see if they throw over. Neither, and he fouls it back. Thames is not going to get much of a lead against Matt Smith.
No, but the thing I like here as a base runner, it's almost a bonus. You got a left-handed pitcher, you can bring the guy down third baseline a long ways. That allows you to get a big lead at first. They pick you off. Now you got the rundown, and you can go ahead and try to make something happen. But if you have a short lead, you're basically conceding the fact that there's not any offense on you. Allow the pitcher to concentrate on the hitter.
Check the swing, called strike three. So both men retired in the inning have been punch-outs, and it leaves it up to Justin Berg.
Well, this is a nasty fastball. Great location. It's a perfect pitch. Now here's a look at what you're seeing with the shadows. It goes from light all of a sudden to dark, and it just becomes a little dot. You're not able to see the seams anymore, and the ball bursts on you.
Justin Berg, not a power guy, gap power. Stands in at 313. Was 1-for-4 in an RBI in his opening game here in the College World Series. Three homers on the year with 49 RBI. Shadows now enveloping both batters' boxes.
Well,
missed outside.
It's interesting, Mike, because we marveled over the fact that Rice they prided themselves in making contact with two strikes. We haven't seen that tonight. We've seen two strikeouts from them early.
I don't know if Matt Smith is a guy to work on hitting two strikes. First and third, two outs, Berg, 1-1. Pops it off the right side, the wind blowing it back in the stands. And McCullough runs out of room over at first base, 1-2.
But you can see that Smith is one of those pitchers that can really overpower a hitter. You get a good look at the flags and the wind there, how hard it's blowing here tonight.
Part of the day in our first game, it was blowing dead in, and it alternates from center field to the plate to blowing out to right field. You better check it constantly, or you're going to get fooled on a pop-up. One and two to Berg. Smith may have overthrown that one. We got it down in the dirt. And we have had so many cloud-covered skies that the sun field in right and right center has not been a problem, but it is today. And it will be for at least another hour. And as the sun gets closer to the rim of that stadium, the worse it gets for the right fielder. 2-2. High fastball, runner goes. Now they pick up on third. They fake the throw back through second, and Smith goes too far off of third, and the gun from Ryan Buddy cut him down.
Well, great execution. Now, this is a call play. They know they're not going to throw it to third. The runner at third base, you're hung out automatically because you're going on arm motion. As soon as the catcher pumps, you're done. You're hoping or guessing that they're going to throw it all the way through. They guessed wrong, and they got it.
Both teams get out of big jams in the first. It's nothing, nothing.
Looking for a fabulous seafood restaurant? I'm Chris King, inviting you out to Kingfish Market on Richmond Avenue. I've got the best seafood Houston has to offer. I'm talking about mouth-watering, great-tasting, lip-smacking good food. For all you lobster lovers, every Wednesday, it's all-you-can-eat live Maine lobster. For great drinks and 25-cent oysters, come to the happiest happy hour every weekday from 3 to 7. Kingfish Market on Richmond Avenue, where fish is our middle name.
I just love spending time in the backyard.
Yeah, just us and the dang bugs.
Excuse me, but haven't you heard of Rooms with a View? Buy a new glass room and use it for games, exercise, or family gatherings. Payments start at $98 a month, plus order now and get free AC. For a free estimate, call Rooms with a View at 1-800-522-2171.
How far away are you from using the internet to respond to a market change? How far away are you from making e-commerce as real as your next shipment? How far away are you from evolving the technology you have today into the solutions you'll need tomorrow? Well, if you build on your existing systems with software you know from Microsoft, like thousands of companies already have, you're closer than you think.
We are back at Omaha. That's just part of the magnificent press box facility here in this magnificent stadium that they improved year after year. Of course, we were willing to take hand grenades to the old press box, but that wasn't necessary. They totally rebuilt everything up here.
Well, this is better than a lot of Major League parks. I mean, you've been to a Tiger Stadium before and sat there.
Oh, this is better than so many parks regardless, so many broadcast facilities regardless, NFL, whatever. This is just a stunningly beautiful setup for us. Chris Becerra, the DH today, will lead it off. 356 on the season. He's a lot better against right-handed pitchers, but even if they go to a lefty early, Tom Holliday says he's just got a feeling about this kid. He's been hot lately, may leave him in.
Well, he's really got a nice, loose approach. Nice and relaxed at the plate. That's the only way you hit. Great hitters are all relaxed. Now watch his hands when he gets ready to hit. Gets in a nice position, and he just relaxes them. He sits there and sees the ball. Watch him take batting practice right there. 2-0 pitch. Hey, I'll take it. I'm seeing things good. Actually, 3-0. And we'll see him turn loose right here if he gets a strike, I'm sure.
Kenny Baugh falls behind again and then pours another fastball in there.
He let it go.
Becerra has 10 home runs this year. Puts it in the dirt and loses him on balls.
Well, that was that 3-2 changeup that he pitched earlier last inning when he was in the jam.
Yeah, but he threw that on 3-2 with the bases loaded.
Yeah. I guess if you have to sit in the exam room at Rice, that's real pressure.
Yeah. Toby Rhodes, the freshman, playing center field today. Getting a start, hitting 306.
What a great name. Is that a big league name?
It works, doesn't it?
Toby Rhodes.
Somebody's got to nickname him Dusty sooner or later.
Yes.
Fastball for a strike. Becerra's got a good lead over at first, but you'd be sort of amazed if he went. He's stolen no bases in two tries this year.
If he does run, it's more than likely going to be a hit and run. And Kenny Baugh, not a bad guy to run on. He's got a high leg kick. And Rhodes is a contact hitter, so not a bad situation, 1-1 pitch. Maybe get the runners moving.
It's only 5'10", 154, but he has six homers this year. In 67 at-bats. That's McGuire-esque, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Went after a high fastball, slapped it foul, 1-2.
It's interesting watching Butera right there. It looked like he might have been on a delayed steal right there. He bounced off a couple times and took off. Now, the key to a delayed steal is you take your big three hops, you get as far out as you can when it crosses the plate, then you head to second.
Look to left. It's going to be a base hit. Williams cuts it off near the line, and Becerra will hold it second. So Rhodes delivers. And another rally going here in the second inning for the Cowboys of Oklahoma State.
Well, he fought that ball inside out, did a nice job of staying with the pitch. And once again, Wayne Graham sitting here wondering, man, my pitcher is in a jam again. No outs, first and second.
Wayne may have to test his back again before the inning's over.
It's tough to be patient and relaxed when your pitcher's got bases loaded, no outs, and now he's got first and second, no outs, and back-to-back inning.
Ryan Buddy, who started out at third, squares around to bunt. They moved him to the catching spot to develop him. And it's really taken off since then.
Well, this right here, as Coach Graham walks on out, is the time to allow their bullpen to get loose again. It's a smart baseball man. You just stop everything right now, walk out here and slow it down.
Tarana and Nichols again. They were up in the first when the bases were loaded with nobody out. Coach Graham just killing a little time and trying to pump up Kenny Baugh.
There's not a whole lot of instruction you can do right there. At this point in time, you just go out and slow the game down. What's he going to tell him?
You know, we all runners in scoring position against Alabama. They were 2-for-10 tonight, 0-for-3. We always talk about pitchers getting ahead in the count. Kenny Baugh has thrown a ball on his first pitch to all nine batters so far.
That's when you end up in those types of jams.
Fastball called, strike 1-1.
Sometimes stats tell the picture. Not all the time, but in that case, it does. 1-0, 0-1. That talks about the at-bat.
Up at first and third, still expecting the bunt. And Buddy tipped a foul. It's 1-2.
You know, maybe that's just the teaching of Oklahoma State, how they run the bases. But every time the base runner at second base gets in the baseline, they've tried to bunt. And when not, they're backing up because they want to get an angle to round third base. But you're also telling the opposition what you're going to do.
Sure are. Somebody down there will pick it up.
Back in the baseline. Let's see if he squares around him with two strikes. Guess not.
Breaking ball just missed high.
Wow. Well, you want that call right there, but when your pitcher's not around the plate, you don't get that call.
That's right. Umpires get into a pattern just like pitchers do. They don't expect it. 2-2 to Buddy. Went after a high breaking ball up in his eyes and hacked it back in the left field seats.
I mean, I'm not sure if he doesn't hit that ball, that doesn't hit him. He hit that back over the grandstand behind us to the left side of the plate. Look at this.
Self-defense. 2-2 to the honorable mention freshman All-American catcher. Hits it to straightaway shallow center. Wind blowing it in and to right. It's going to be a tough play. It drops. The bases are going to be loaded. Gray had a problem coming up with it. And it's a bloop single for Buddy.
Well, you got to play so deep in this ballpark to respect the wind and how the ball carries that it's a long run for the center fielder. We caught a few balls fall in the earlier games because the center fielders have to play so deep, the outfielders in general. Thames went a long way to get that, but he's playing double play depth. You couldn't have thrown the ball any better right there.
Now back to the top of the order, and we have the bases loaded with nobody out for the second straight inning. Oklahoma State did not score in the first. Gautreaux, who singled to start the ball game. He takes a ball.
He gets out of this one. We're changing his name to Harry Houdini. I mean, that's right. There's back-to-back bases loaded situations.
And he's taking a few months off Wayne Graham's life every time he does it. High fastball popped up. Curry runs out of room, and the wind helped him a little bit there.
You know, the one thing about the college game, Mike, they do a better job of tipping the hitter of what pitch is coming than any time that you play. I remember in college, we would let the hitter know what was coming all the time. The more you progress, the more people become aware of that. But that's how you get a guy hitting a breaking ball behind his neck, because he knows what's coming. You got a runner at second base tipping your pitches. It's a little easier to hit.
1-1. Downstairs, 2-1.
I mean, if I'm Rice right now and I'm playing defense, I see the approach the hitters take. I'm going out to the mound and we're going to change our sequence because obviously Oklahoma State is doing a great job of tipping pitches.
Gautreaux chops it to third. They step on the bag, throw home. They've got to make the tag. Double play. Chopped right to third. Fox comes up with it, steps on the bag, and then as opposed to the other night, makes a perfect throw to Zane Curry at the plate.
Well, Fox has the presence of mind, Mike, to step on the base and come home, because most guys would have gone to maybe second base thinking about a triple play. But right here, he makes a great throw because he doesn't have an angle to throw the ball. You got the runner coming straight down the line. It's great to see a young man be able to come back after the horrible night he had throwing the ball and say, hit it to me, I want to make a throw.
So two outs, a runner at first. This ball is hit hard to center field. Jason Gray broke in, then goes back. They get out of another jam.
Harry Houdini.
That's right. He is officially no longer Kenny Ball. He is Harry Houdini. He's gotten out of it twice.
Time to get washed, Daddy's almost home. Honey, can you wash your feet? Hey, I hear Daddy.
Hey, guys!
Hi. Hey, honey.
Okay, let's eat.
Hey, where are the fries?
What, no fries? I can't believe Daddy forgot the fries. I'll go get some more. Some.
Hurry back, fry breath.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
The X Games. The only extreme event that matters. The X Games, June 27th to July 5th. Presented by Mountain Dew.
Sign my next, Buster, please.
Buster!
Just play Larry!
Busted, it is so cool! Dude, wait! Hang on, Busted, bye! Wait, Busted, wait! Totally awesome! Yeah. Hey, Busted, dude, where'd you go?
It may look like a scoreless game, but we have had multiple opportunities in an inning and a half. First inning, Matthews up with the bases loaded. Ball gets out of the inning on a forced play. Bases loaded, nobody out. Bottom half of the inning, Rice makes a threat, and then a runner picked off third. And then here's the double play, Fox initiating it. And Harry Houdini Ball has gotten out of two straight, bases loaded, nobody out jams. And I'll bet Wayne Graham said something to him as he came in. No more, young man, no more of those. Justin Berg will lead it off. Berg was up when his teammate was picked off third.
That was great execution by Oklahoma State, because you know with two strikes and two outs, they're going to try to do something to force a run. And they caught him in the first and third backdoor play.
Oklahoma State has four hits in the first two innings and nothing to show for it. The wind freshening again. Berg turns on one and knocks it through the hole. Sometimes with a fastball pitcher, Harold, don't you see, you don't even have to be up the first time. Your teammates help you time it, and your eyes sitting in the dugout help you time that pitch.
Absolutely, and even on the on-deck circle, before you go up there to hit, you should be going through your at-bat with the pitch as he's throwing the ball. You sit there while the pitcher's throwing, you gauge him, and then you get up to the plate, particularly with a guy like Matt Smith who doesn't change speeds on his fastball. He's just reaching back. It's going to be hard or harder. It's not going to be a BP fastball or anything else. He's going to come after you.
Jason Gray, who has raised his average up to 328 in the last month, moved from number 2 to 5 in the order, and it's really helped him. Up and in. It's unusual. He leads the team in home runs and stolen bases as well.
Well, Rice is going to try to beat you base to base because Coach Graham said, I don't like to give up an out.
Trying after to steal. A high fastball and doesn't get around on it. Of course, with this wind, sometimes you're going to have to play situational baseball, aren't you? You're not going to jack too many out of here today.
Well, the team that's going to end up eventually winning this whole thing is the team that can play no matter what brand of baseball you want to play. They're going to be fundamentally sound.
1-1 to Jason Gray. Tried to bunt on a curveball, popped it in the air, and Holiday just couldn't get there. Heck of an effort by Josh Holiday at third. Well, that looked like one of those deals you made up your mind you were going to do it no matter what.
Well, he has such great baseball instincts. Now, you see him already coming up. He was anticipating the bunt, and he just wasn't able to get there, just nipped off the end of his glove. Great effort. Now, he's shown us a lot of athletic ability. This is really a catcher playing third base. He was drafted in the draft. He played 3 years at catcher here. Moved to third this year kind of on an emergency basis, and
exactly.
He stayed there. But he's going to be a catcher in pro baseball.
And his goal coming back for his senior year was to help his dad get here to Omaha. Fastball foul back out of play, and it was interesting. Tom Holiday said, you know, he was sort of split between a father and a coach because he thinks as a junior, if you're going to be drafted and the money is right, there's no reason to stay in school unless you're a good student. And his son is a 3.8 student, so he said that may have made the decision a little easier. Mm-hmm. 1-2 to Gray. Check throw to first.
Well, it's interesting watching the game. There's more involvement in this ball game with the season on the line. The coaches are taking control. We're seeing guys bunting. We're seeing them try to move runners over, pickoffs, combination of steals, a lot of different things.
Berg at first with a good lead, nobody out. Goes after another one up in his eyes and fouls it out of play.
It's great to see these kind of games because it brings out the best baseball.
I couldn't agree with you more. I'm not a big fan of those 21-14 jobs.
Mm-mm.
Ripped to center. Berg around second. He'll hold there as Rhodes comes up with it quickly. And another threat for the Owls.
There's a two-out base hit by Rice. That is what they are known for. Staying inside the baseball, inside out. Great piece of hitting.
Two strike.
I said two out. Two strike.
John Farrell, the pitching coach, is the guy who is sending out the signs to Matt Smith.
7 years of major league experience himself, his seven years pitching the big leagues. He also played college baseball here at Oklahoma State in that program. He's got a little bit of experience.
Rice has had two on in each inning. Oklahoma State has had the bases loaded and nobody out. Two straight innings, and we have no runs. Baker, a 324 hitter. Fastball just missed outside. Looks like Rich Fetch at the home plate umpire is not going to be overly generous with the strike zone, and I like that as well. I think the strike zone is the strike zone, don't you?
Oh, no doubt. You know, you see guys setting up way outside. If he sets up in the dugout and they hit him, is it a strike? No.
That one hangs high, 2-0. And Matt Smith giving himself a little problem here. Baker, the seventh man in the order. And there's going to be some action shortly in the Oklahoma State bullpen, as neither of these coaches can afford to let this thing get away from them. Could be two. Lucas to Gasparino to McCullough. They turned it beautifully. And Baker bounces into a 4-6-3 double play.
Well, they sure did. And Lucas showed us the other night the type of hands he has. Now, this is a short hop that he fields. He played this beautifully because it came off a weird hop. He got high chopper and then in between. But watch him play the short hop. And then Gasparino shows the great footwork just and the strong arm to roll this over. Nice job by the two of them up the middle. See the short hop there? He stayed with it. You know, you play that little game short hop, and sometimes it pays off in games. You sit there and play a little short hop in the backyard, and eventually it will come into play.
Lucas used to be a shortstop, known for having very soft hands. So a runner at third and two out for Zane Curry. And Smith, again, one out away from getting out of a big jam. The emotions in this game have gone back and forth so quickly. Ripped to center field. Rose on his horse, and he can't get there. Over his glove, the run is home. Curry headed for second. He's in with a stand-up RBI double, and Rice leads it 1-0.
That ball started cutting in the wind. I thought Rose was going to get to it. Maybe even have to lay out. It was kind of in between. Do I dive or do I run this ball down? This is a great swing. He's driven in the left center field. Rhodes got a good jump, and the ball starts to cut back on him. I thought he might lay out for it right there. Just nipped off the end of his glove, Mike.
So close, and it looked like the wind was trying to help him, driving it back toward him. But that was smoked by Curry. His 12th double of the year. Rice has the lead, and here's Matt Fox, the number nine hitter. Smith in there with a strike. Now four hits given up by Smith. Fox hitting at 308, made so many spectacular plays the other night with his glove, and then had three throwing errors. Down the right field line. Slicing foul into the stands, 0-2. Let's go back and watch the play that Fox made. Brooks Robinson couldn't have done it any better. Turned it into a double play to get his club out of a big jam. But then three poor throws, two to first and one to the plate. Former shortstop who never had throwing problems from there. But when you change positions, it changes angles. I don't know why, but it does.
Well, it does, and also, those plays that he made, the throwing errors on, those are hurry plays. You know, you're rushing on the play, and you're going to end up forcing yourself to get in a situation that you're normally not used to. I usually didn't worry about young players. If they catch the ball, you've done half the problem.
Yeah. Swung over the top, and they got it. So Oklahoma State strands a runner at third, but there is a run home on the RBI double by Curry. End of two, 1-0.
Boy, you're sweating like crazy.
You got TV cameras all over you.
We asked the hottest pros under the sun to switch antiperspirants.
Invisible solid? What's that?
Degree Invisible Solid is body heat activated with a clear difference.
Right there. See, there's no white stuff.
Degree works hard but never shows.
You gotta be cool.
It's party time. Hot tubs everywhere will be overflowing. Make sure your deck can take the heat with Thompson's Wood Protector. For rain, sun, mildew, it's the most powerful Thompson's yet. Thompson's Wood Protector. It never takes a day off.
great moments in college sports, make great memories, and often inspire great achievement beyond the game. Come see it all at the Hall, the new NCAA Hall of Champions, a place to relive the action, savor the memories, discover what it means to be a true champion, and that might be the greatest moment sports has ever produced. The NCAA Hall of Champions, opening in downtown Indianapolis in March 2000.
It would have been easy to have been a football player and not a student. And conversely, it would have been much easier to have been just a student and left football for some other day and time. But it wouldn't have been as joyous, as rich, as humbling to have been one without the other. So for all of us, I say thank you from the bottom of my heart. Not for a single award on a single night, but for the many memorable and molding moments that we have had the privilege to call ourselves student athletes.
We'll go to the top of the third here in Omaha, Nebraska, with a 1-0 lead for the Rice Owls. Mike Patrick, Harold Reynolds, Dave Ryan with you. Glad you could join us from the College World Series. We've already had a lot of fun out here, and we're only to Sunday. Gasparino will come up for his second opportunity at bat. Walked in his first trip.
And there's his first strike of the game of a leadoff pitch. You were saying earlier that he had not thrown a strike to any hitter on the first pitch.
This one's chopped foul. And I'm sure Wayne Graham and his assistant coaches made a point of that in the dugout between innings. You will start throwing strikes on the first pitch.
But you will be gone.
That's right. Just missed inside on the 0-2 pitch.
Uh-oh.
High and deep to left. Williams at the wall. The wind holds it up and he makes the catch on the track.
Oh, my goodness. You called it, Mike. The wind cut that ball down because that was a great swing by Gasparino.
Gasparino has 24 home runs. Gave it a ride.
Stayed on this breaking ball. Got out in front just a little bit. Maybe that wasn't why he was able to drive it out of the park, but in this ballpark, you would think it would go. Williams does a great job of going back to the wall, finds where he's at. He's ready to leap if he needs to. You see the wind knock it down.
15 to 20 mile an hour wind is what you're hitting against. And this one is ripped by Holiday in a right center field. Makes the big turn and goes back to first. So both teams are hitting the ball very, very well against two quality pitchers. That's nine hits between the two clubs, but we've only hit one run so far.
Now, this is a young man I'm waiting to see get on track. He hasn't had a good at-bat yet. He hasn't had an opportunity to be ahead in the hitter, ahead of the pitcher, and get a pitch to hit. 391.
That gesture by Lamont Matthews for his late mother, who he lost at the age of two. And if he hits a home run, he comes around third and does the same thing, crosses himself and looks to the sky. And some people have criticized him. He says he's being a hot dog about it, but it's not. It's a tribute to his late mother. The heart of this order, Gasparino, Holiday, McCullough, and Matthews hitting a combined 3-for-20 here in the College World Series. That's 150.
And that's one of the reasons that Oklahoma State has struggled offensively. When you don't have the heart of the lineup picking it up, because they've had opportunities to drive runs in.
You start rooting for Matthews. You don't want to see this young man come and just have a horrible College World Series, which he has had so far. Three called strikes and a swinging strike to start this game. You'd like to see a kid like this succeed. I mean, he hit nearly 430 homers, led the nation with 105 RBIs. And Oklahoma State, as always, plays a quality schedule, so he hasn't been getting this against the junior college circuit.
And he's not a guy that strikes out a whole lot. So, you know, he's pressing a little bit, when you start to strike out. I remember I'd strike out once or twice in a game. I'm swinging at the first pitch I see after that. You throw me a strike, you got me out. I'm going to make contact. It's a moral victory. Because you start to press, that's a natural tendency.
One out, one on. Matthews slaps this one towards short. Thames to Schmidt on to first. They turn the double play beautifully.
Thames got that ball out of his glove so quick. That's what allowed that double play to be turned. Sweet, sweet hand.
My partner becoming a huge Damon Thames fan. 6-4-3 double play after the long fly ball.
Love spending time in the backyard.
Yeah, just us and the dang bugs.
Excuse me, but haven't you heard of Rooms with a View? Buy a new glass room and use it for games, exercise, or family gatherings. Payments start at $98 a month, plus order now and get free AC. For a free estimate, call Rooms with a View at 1-800-522-2171.
Coulada from Dunkin' Donuts. Nothing's more beautiful on a hot day.
We want to give back to the community, and that's why a lot of us are involved in the Big Buddy program. Chance to give children something they would otherwise never see, to meet their heroes.
When I pass it to you, just give it right back. All right, now give it back! Oh!
What are you doing? Shooting! Pass the ball! Pass the ball!
Easy, man. Be a Big Buddy.
Being a Big Buddy allows us to give back, and, you know, that feels pretty good.
Get up! Walk off! Your parents signed the permission slip. Get up, man.
We're in the bottom of the third at the College World Series. 1-0 Rice over Oklahoma State, and the College World Series continues tomorrow afternoon with second-round games from Bracket 2. From the winner's draw, Florida State takes on Stanford over on ESPN. Then the nightcap on the deuce, Texas A&M against Cal State Fullerton. It's another elimination game. Earlier today in Bracket 1, Miami moved to a 2-0 record by defeating Alabama. They get to sit and rest while Bama takes on the winner of this game on Tuesday. Nine combined hits, one run. The pitchers have gotten out of jams when they've had to.
Yeah, a lot of people think that's lucky, but it's actually an art to know when to throw the right pitch in the right situation. Sometimes it's luck.
Well, you always need a little of that. Williams has struck out his first time up and is 0-3 here in Omaha. Fouls this one back out of play over the roof on the right side.
Williams, another guy struggling, hasn't got a chance to be real aggressive at the plate. He finally got into a hitter's count and took a good rip right there.
The young man has gotten better every single year under Wayne Graham from Humble, Texas. There's Houdini. Just inside. That was the pitch that Matt Smith really wanted. Thought he had the corner.
Well, it looks like to me in the college game, you get the outside pitch more than you will the inside pitch. Umpires will give you that outside call.
That one's downstairs, 3-2. As long as they're consistent and it's a reasonable strike zone, the hitters will adjust to it immediately.
Absolutely.
Tipped into the glove of Ryan Buddy.
And a great indication of what you're talking about, Mike, was in the Miami game. You know, they pitched them outside, outside, outside. They were getting them out. And the next thing you know, the Miami hitters got on top of the plate, and they started taking away that outside strike and broke the game open.
Four strikeouts for Matt Smith. And Brett Smith stands in. Last week, broke his nose when he was hit by a pitch in a ball game. Graham, in what sounds like one of my attempts at humor, said he's a hard-nosed kid, he'll play anyway.
Shameless.
It was funnier when he said it. And I'm just passing it on. Here's the 2-0. Swung over the top, 2-1.
What?
Talk to Dave Ryan, see what he's up to. David?
Well, Mike, as you and Harold were talking about, the Oklahoma State pitchers have a big advantage. Their pitching coach, John Farrell, threw himself, as Harold said, for 7 years in the majors. Farrell tells us he has a lot to offer the players at State, not just on pitching mechanics, but what life is like in the minor leagues, too. John Farrell works with the State pitchers on mental approach as well. He stresses being relentless on the mound, having that bend but not break attitude when things aren't going smoothly. And guys, he says he's really impressed with Matt Smith's mental makeup and a great approach. And someday, he thinks he's going to make a great pro.
Well, Dave, there have been an awful lot of them coming out of this program over the years. Oklahoma State, one of the truly fine baseball schools in the country, and they have been for years and years. 2-2 to Brett Smith from Matt Smith here in the Rice third inning.
What an advantage to be around a coach who's been through what you want to go through. Anytime you can take advantage of the wisdom of another person and apply it to your life, you should consider yourself fortunate.
You know, there are a lot of guys who made the major leagues simply because of the physical skills that they had. Those guys don't turn out to be good teachers. Some of them never really knew how they did what they did. This one popped up on the infield. McCullough, right on the line, will take it for the out.
No, you're absolutely right. It's tough to explain how you do things unless you really are a person that is mentally into the game and understands what it takes to get there. And really, most of the time, some of the best athletes are the guys that don't have the great ability because they have to figure out how to do it.
Two out, nobody on here in the third. Thames, who singled his first trip up and is 2-for-5 in Omaha in the College World Series. They were just delighted when this young man came back for his senior year. He has struggled some, particularly in power numbers this season, because of the great expectations from him. Hit 26 home runs, had 115 RBIs last season, and hit 424. It's pretty tough to match, let alone improve on.
Yeah, that's a big, big year right there.
And when you put up those kind of numbers, they tend to pitch around you. This one's hit on the ground to Gasparino and right through. Gasparino, much more of an offensive than a defensive shortstop, and has had his problems mostly with throwing errors, but that time he brought the gate up.
Yeah, that ball, it looks like, now on this infield, we talked about it earlier, he just got off to the side of that ball, but the grass is high and the dirt is fast. So we've seen a lot of infielders. You see Thames coming around. He was going hard the whole way. He was thinking about going to second base, just another way to slow yourself down. but we see the ground ball here. The grass is high and the dirt is fast. And a lot of infielders are overrunning the ball.
It was the 35th error this year charged to the shortstop, Billy Gasparino. The coaches say he has excellent tools at short, but is going to need a lot of reps to hone those skills. Will Ford cuts on a fastball and didn't get it.
Yeah, talking with Coach Holliday the other day, he was saying this is Gasparino's the type of young man who you give him 500 games in the minor leagues, then he's going to be able to figure out how to play shortstop. But in a college season where you're playing 50, 60 games, it's going to be magnified because he doesn't have the time to work on it every day.
This one is off the glove of Buddy, and Thames will get second base.
We're talking so much about the hitters having a tough time with shadows. Well, the catchers have a tough time with the shadows also. This is the ball right here. Matt Smith throws it, just cuts away and actually ends up jamming Buddy. It didn't cross him up, but it caught him on the heel of his glove, handcuffed him.
But Buddy checking for signs in the dugout. And relays them on to Matt Smith. It's a passed ball on the catcher, allowing the runner to go into second. Now a man in scoring position with two out. Strike three called. It doesn't matter. Smith gets out of the jam himself. Five strikeouts for Matt Smith, and he survives another scoring situation.
What time it is?
Dad. Ooh, see, it was a party, you know, and Vicky, you know, Vicky.
Alien abduction shouldn't keep you out past your curfew. Now, this is gonna hurt you more than it's gonna hurt me.
No, Dad.
All beef patties, special sauce. Sing it with me, son.
Lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, on the sesame seed bun.
We got some fries, too. Yeah.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
Did you get them brakes at Pep Boys?
Yeah, I did.
I appreciate it.
Get quality parts and brake service from just $79.99.
Pep Boys.
Cars like us.
People love us.
Yeah, they stink. But with the new Sony Digital 8 Handy Cam with stamina battery power, they can stink for up to 10 hours and still look great. 8mm has gone digital.
Either you can surrender in the face of adversity, or you can dunk in its face.
She's sending out her wedding invitations with her personal 800 number, because now all her calls are just a dime every time. You too can live happily ever after. Call Sprint at 1-800-PIN-DROP now.
They love it here in Omaha, whether they're following their own team or they're from Omaha, Nebraska, or across the river in Iowa or the surrounding environment where 80% of the crowds come from. Record crowds one session after another here at the College World Series again. And I get the feeling they could put 2,000 or 3,000 more seats every year in this place and they would still manage to fill them up.
Yeah, and that's without Nebraska or Iowa entry either.
Creighton.
Can't imagine if one of those teams made it here.
When Creighton and Wichita State were here, it was something else, boy, I'll tell you. Jay McCullough leads it off here in the Oklahoma State four, wraps a foul outside third. Creighton and Wichita State both in the tournament this year, and there was some rumbling in Omaha that we might get a rematch out of it. Breaking pitch just ticked foul.
Pretty exciting to see.
And when they played, I remember the night game. Runner was thrown out at the plate in the ninth inning to end the game. It was something else. One of the best events I ever saw, regardless of the sport, regardless of where we were. It was just a magnificent evening. Two and two fouled away.
Now, Mike, we were talking about Kenny Baugh earlier and how inconsistent he has been, but here's one of the reasons. Watch his windup. Now, you get a head-on look here, but watch how he steps across his body, then tries to throw back over. Anytime you try to throw to a target, you always want to square up with that target. If you miss it, you're going to be inconsistent. He's so gifted and athletic that he's able to still get strikeouts and throw, but somebody someday is going to straighten up that windup. See him stepping off, and he's not even driving to his target. When he gets squared away, he's going to be something.
Well, you've already renamed him Houdini. We know he can get out of trouble. Took something off and it dropped low to Chris Becerra, who walked his first time up in the second inning. We are in the Oklahoma State fourth. Fastball missed 2-0. Oklahoma State with five hits, as you see the numbers on Becerra at 356 after that walk, and have had multiple scoring opportunities. Last inning was the only time they went 1-2-3, and they needed a double play to do that. They've had hits in every inning. Bases loaded, nobody out in the first and second. There's a strike call, 3-1.
You just get the sense that Oklahoma State is going to bust out. They've been walking a tightrope on them the whole time, and they just haven't been able to explode yet.
This one is ripped down the right field line into the corner. Becerra around first on his way to second as Will Ford digs it out, and Becerra with a stand-up double. Your timing is remarkable.
Well, I've been doing a lot of games here in Omaha. I'm starting to get a feel for it.
You've done them all?
Yeah. Well, he gets a 3-1 fastball. Now, last time he had a 3-1 fastball, he got the bat out late. This time he gets the bat head out. This ball's even on the outside half, but he knew what he was going to get, and he turns on it and drives it down the line, and this is a double the whole way, and he knew it.
I hope we're providing the stimulants that's keeping you and Dave Ryan awake at night so you can study doing two games a day. Of course, our crew is out here doing the same exact thing. All the cameramen, the tape people, the audio guys.
Every night, Dave and I go to dinner, and I tell him, you do all the work, man. You, Mike, and Gary, you guys got to do all the research. I just sit here and talk baseball all night long. But the crew does all
the
work. Yes, indeed.
Jim and Marty, the cameramen, this one's fouled away. And I tell you what, people put their name on the list early to come back to Omaha. This is one of the prized events we have all year long.
Well, the fun thing is when everybody gets together at the end of the night. You get a chance to know people. Usually when you do a game in the middle of the week, everybody hops on a plane the next day and they're gone.
Rhodes takes this one outside, 1-2.
The beauty of this is we're all here for 10 days and see everybody, get to know the names and spend time swapping stories.
We've already lost track of what day it is a couple of days ago, so we have to be reminded that today is Sunday. Slap toward third. Fox comes up. Another high throw, but the first baseman, Baker, comes down in time, and Fox's heart's got to be up in his throat.
Well, he's starting to think a little bit, but did you see how strong Baker is?
He was run into and didn't even budge.
He sets himself, and right there he guided it a little bit. Now watch Baker come down. He goes, you're not coming through here. It's a strong kid right there. Fox is going to jump. Oh, get up. Oh, thank you.
Well, Toby Rhodes is 5'10", 154. He's not going to steamroll too many guys. Two outs now. Breaking ball is high. Buddy, who runs very, very well for a catcher from Midwest City, Oklahoma. He's 5'10", 182. Only a freshman with a great future. Another breaking ball is hot. Kenny Ball has allowed 6 hits, but no runs.
This is a great game for his future, to understand that he can pitch in jams and still come back and throw his fastball.
Buddy lofts it down the right field line. This one is twisting foul. Ford gave it the long run and couldn't get there.
And what I mean by that is a lot of pitchers will get into jams and they will become scared and not aggressive. He's been aggressive. He uses fastball to set up the great changeup we saw earlier. He continues to challenge the hitters even though he's been in the jam.
You got to have the guts of a burglar to throw that changeup that he threw with the bases loaded. Nobody out on 3-2. Because he was ready to get the hook.
Yeah, they had the bullpen hot, and coach's temper was flaring a little bit, too.
3-1 to Buddy, the number 9 hitter, who singled his first time up, his first hit here in Omaha. Ball's already thrown 80 pitches. Make it 81, and that was for a strike.
The interesting thing about this field is that everybody came out of the region the number 1, except for one team, Oklahoma State, which battled its way through. So no team came here happy to be in Omaha. They want to win it here.
This one's fouled back. You're absolutely right. Oklahoma State, as you said, when they went to the super regional format for 2 out of 3 after the regionals, it was basically designed, if they seeded it right, they felt the top 8 seeds would get here, and you would have truly the best 8 teams in the country. But Oklahoma State decided they were one of the best teams in the country, and they upset the apple cart.
Yep.
And they lost Buddy. So first and second with two gone. And back to the top of the order for Gautreau.
Maybe he just likes to pitch in a jam. Maybe it relaxes him.
Some guys are so much better in that situation. You've probably seen it your entire career. People do not bear down, it seems, sometimes, unless there's trouble.
We had a pitcher in Seattle at 30-some saves, Mike Schuller. Every night it was a cardiac save.
On the ground toward the second baseman, Brett Smith, bad hop into right center field. That's going to tie the ball game. Looked like a routine play. Instead, it's a 1-1 tie.
Sometimes you need a break, and Oklahoma State picked one up right here. Now, there's been a lot of batting practice, a lot of games played. This ball, this is just a nasty hop. He stays with it as long as he can, and he even tried to block it with the broken nose and all. He stayed down there, but it took the nasty last-second hop. Nothing you can do about that. He hung in there fearless with the nose and all, Mike.
And Kenny Ball was smiling about it. He knows that sometimes there's nothing you can do. And Thames is talking to Smith. You just shake your head and say, well, maybe those are leaving out. But Wayne Graham comes out to calm down his club. Sometimes kids get so emotional over things like that that they can mess up the next play as well, and he doesn't want that.
And the funny thing, years from now, you'll forget about the jams that Kenny was able to wiggle out of, and he'll say, man, I got that bad hop.
That's right.
When I got that bad hop, they'd have never scored.
Runners at first and third again with two out for Kevin Lucas from Festus, Missouri.
It's a great situation for Lucas to bunt again.
Hit wide at third into the hole.
A diaper dandy. I'm telling you, we're looking at one of the premier shortstops you'll see for years to come. Great play out of the hole.
With Matchlighter, you get the best charcoal, Kingsford, with just the right amount of lighter fluid already added. That's why there's only one match for Match Light. Match Light from Kingsford.
I'll see you.
Hi, man.
Me too.
Me too?
Ah, the credit card game. We've all played it.
I'll go 5.9%.
That an intro rate?
Yeah.
First, you get a great introductory rate, but then it goes up.
So you'll raise us to 17.9% in 6 months?
Yeah.
But now, if you have good credit, you can win the credit card game by calling 1-800-438-5544.
Let's make it interesting.
I'm out. I'll call.
With the 9.9% fixed rate Visa Platinum card from Capital One.
Fixed?
That's a great hand.
It's not an introductory rate. You get a low fixed rate you can trust, platinum perks, and no annual fee. Act now. Call 1-800-438-5544. Transfer your high interest balances to the 9.9% fixed rate Visa Platinum from Capital One and save hundreds, even thousands of dollars a year. Call 1-800-438-5544 and win the credit card game.
Tied at one in the bottom of the fourth. Let's go back and take another well-deserved look at shortstop Damon Thames, who saved the lead run from scoring with his play in the hole. Fox dives and can't get it. Thames going away from the play, still with the power in his arm to get it to Brett Smith.
And it looked like he was starting to round the base because he thought the ball was going to be in the left field. That's a tribute to the range of Thames. Even the base runner didn't think he was going to get there. You know, Mike, I watched this young man take ground balls the other day, and I turned to you immediately and I said, you know what? He's one of the smoothest shortstops I have seen. And I've been around some great ones.
I remembered you watching him take infield and said, hey, look at this. What? Just watch this kid pick and how smooth he is. No wasted effort, no wasted motion. Matt Smith will now face Rice here in the bottom of the fourth, and Justin Berg will lead it off. He is one for one with a single and two for five in the College World Series. Those plays can pick you up just like a home run does. And certainly that was a play that saved one run and could have saved a continuing rally.
That was a tremendous play. And you're right, Mike. That's the thing about being an infielder or even anybody on the field. If you don't bring your offense, do something defensively to help your club. That's why shortstop is such a valuable position. Defense is so overlooked in the big leagues now because everybody wants a shortstop to hit with power.
Well, you played with one who hit with power, Cal.
Yeah, I played with Cal a long time. Cal made plays like that when he was a shortstop, too. That's the beauty of having a guy who has power and range. You know, we're fortunate to see Jeter Rodriguez and Nomar Garciaparra and even Alex Gonzalez, a kid in Florida. That's rare that they can do all those combinational things.
The wind carries this one back in the stands. All right, who was the best shortstop you ever saw? And you better have the right answer.
Well, I ever saw defensively, I'd have to say Ozzie Smith.
There you go. Perfect.
I mean, there was nobody like the Wizard.
No, there sure was.
These guys are imitations of Ozzie Smith.
Spike Owen up there on the board.
I played with Spike in Seattle. The thing, you know who reminds me of him in this tournament, I was telling him today, is Bobby Hill from Miami. Spike was consistent, caught everything. Uh-oh.
Gap shot to right center, but back on the track is Matthews. Let's go to Dave Hine. Dave, what do you have?
Well, Mike, thanks a lot. We talked a lot about the 50th anniversary of the College World Series here in Omaha. This may be the best section in terms of loyalty and great fans. This is Section F, Row 12. And along the way here, we've got Pearl and Paul Tatro. They've been coming for at least 37, 38 years, they say, anyway. We've also got Don Williamson back here from Council Bluffs, Iowa. He's been coming for about 40 years. And then down here is perhaps our favorite fan. Always talks to us every time we go by. It's Joe Potter. Now, Joe, you've enjoyed some great college baseball here over the years. What's your top memory?
Well, my top memory, I've seen a lot of great players here. I've seen Bob Horner and Reggie Jackson, people like that. But I think the best overall baseball player I ever saw in this series was 1962, I believe, was Bob Garibaldi from Santa Clara. Without a doubt, probably the best athlete that I ever did see. He was a fielder, a pitcher, and a shortstop, whatever. And he had an outstanding series and lost the game on a home run. It was a heartbreaker. It went into extra innings.
Thanks a lot, Joe, for joining us. We appreciate that. Joe, by the way, guys, is a native right here of Omaha, and he's picked Oklahoma State this year to root for.
I'll tell you what, Dave, they certainly love their baseball here. As we've said before, 80% of the people that buy tickets here are locals. And they have supported this tournament to an incredible degree. It's one of the reasons it's been here for 50 years.
Hard fastball, throws it right by him. Bob Garibaldi fastball right there. I didn't see him back in 64, but you can imagine.
That is the sixth strikeout for Matt Smith. And he has lived up to the hope of Coach Holliday that he would be on tonight. He has been. Gotten in some trouble, given up four hits, but surrendered only one run. Jacob Baker up there with the bases empty and two gone here in the Rice half of the fourth inning. Every year that I've been coming here, there has been an unlikely hero. Warren Morris is the first guy that springs to mind for LSU with a game-winning home run. But somebody who isn't that much of a hitter just goes on a tear here in Omaha and becomes the star. And not speaking of Warren Morris, of course, because he's in the majors now with the Pirates. But there are a lot of guys, this is the last time they're ever going to play baseball seriously, and it's going to be the greatest memory they've ever had.
Yeah, and it's going to stay with them forever. And etched in their mind. What a way to go out if you're a hero.
Absolutely. Jacob Baker, 2-2. Back up the middle and through for a base hit. Baker's first hit of the ball game, his third in the College World Series. Ball gets away, but everybody involved in backing it up. Largest crowd ever for a College World Series game, Dave Ryan. We've got it tonight. 24,859. We've been in the 23s, and they just continue to set records session after session after session. Our hats off to the people of Omaha, Nebraska, and all the communities around here. You have done a magnificent job again.
We're not even to the final round yet.
They're going to have to start putting up wooden bleachers somewhere. Zane Curry stands in as Rice tries to get a two-out rally going.
Well, I think, Mike, there's a couple of reasons for that. It's quite a tribute to college baseball, too. I think, you know, you turn on the TV now and you see a lot of former college baseball players playing in the big
leagues. And for a long time, there were only a few exceptions to it. Most kids who played in the major leagues came right out of high school. And then for some reason, we hit that wall where better athletes started going to college, getting an education as well as a baseball background. And it has certainly helped this sport. And the people don't come out here just out of civic pride. They come out to be entertained, and they have been entertained now for 50 years. I've seen some outstanding players, some outstanding baseball games.
Yeah, even like the gentleman down there was talking about his favorite moment. He mentioned Reggie Jackson had been here, and Barry Bonds, and Freddie Lynn. But those weren't the guys that stood out in his mind when it came to the College World
Correct.
Series.
Big swing and a miss struck him out. The seventh of the game for Matt Smith. We've played four here in Omaha. We're tied at one.
Well, we had a fiscal year. It was a good year. If you look at the charts, you'll see the arrow goes up, which is good, as opposed to going down. So in conclusion, that's it.
Savan pants. Soft, comfortable, stylish. So you'll look good no matter what happens.
What will it take to build this company?
To get ready for prime time on the web.
How can we do everything a little faster? Okay, a lot faster.
When they're looking for answers, more CIOs, more webmasters, more people, look to Compaq than to any other computer company in the world.
Limits? What limits?
Compaq. Better answers.
Range Rover, the most advanced thinking ever found in a 4x4. And now, for a limited time, lease a Range Rover 4.0 SE and get the first month free.
The 1999 NCAA College World Series, celebrating 50 years in Omaha.
We played four here in Omaha, Oklahoma State and Rice, in a pressure-packed elimination game, knotted at one. 12 hits so far, but only two runs, as both pitchers have found ways to get out of jams, and there have been plenty of them. And Kenny Baugh faced his own mortality early. Bases loaded, top of the first, nobody out, got out of it. Bases loaded, top of the second, nobody out, got out of it. Been in a couple of minor jams after that, but giving up only one run, and it came on a bad hop.
Yeah, minor jam is first and second, no outs.
Gasparino leads it off here in the fifth, took something off and got it over. Gasparino, a 17th round draft choice of the Colorado Rockies, a senior from Tampa. Pops it up. Buddy, the catcher, in foul territory. Or excuse me, Zane Curry, the catcher, in foul territory. One gone. Tune in next Monday at 7:30. Bob Lee hosts a special, Outside the Lines, that takes a look at the widespread nature of bad behavior exhibited by young high school athletes. That's Outside the Lines next Monday at 7:30 on ESPN. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com. And we are so proud of Bob Lee and that series of Outside the Lines programs. They have been exceptional since the beginning of that series and explored many of the things that we need to talk about more.
Well, you can talk about Dan Rather and Walter Cronkite and all those guys. That's what Bob Lee is to sports. He is incredible being around the center and seeing him work and then seeing how he comes across on TV. I love the guy.
They have not only looked at some of the subjects that are very necessary, but Bob has been extremely fair, I think, in all the reports that he has done. They examine the issues not from a one-sided perspective, and our hats are off to him. And that's not an easy thing to do, either.
No, it's not. Especially nowadays, trying to be objective and fair. You got so many people coming at you from so many angles.
One out, nobody on. Another sky-high pop-up this time. Baker, the first baseman in foul territory. Two gone.
Boy, he just missed that ball. He got the pitch he was looking for. You know, he lined the ball for a base hit the last time up. Each at bat getting a little bit better. And Josh Holliday gets a fastball right where he wants it, and he knows that he just missed that ball. Yelling at himself going down to first base.
Coach's son trying to give his dad the lead. And almost did. Two out now in a rapidly moving fifth inning for Lamont Matthews.
I'd like to hear this conversation. He's probably telling him, you know what, Lamont, just relax. You're pressing a little bit. Holliday does such a great job with the young kids.
Matthews in five official at-bats in the College World Series, four strikeouts, and he's hit into a double play. This is the last guy on anybody's roster you would expect to do this. There's the strikeout. And then with another threat, bounces into the 6-4-3 double play. Now he's up with nobody on and two out here in the fifth. Rips that one, and it hooks foul. Had a good cut.
Well, he hasn't offered out a first pitch, though, whole series. And I think that might be one of the things that Ron Holliday was telling him right there. Go up there and be aggressive. That wasn't one of those little conversations. Okay, get a fastball, let it go. It was a little longer than that, and he told him, go up there, be aggressive, relax. You got us here. There's no pressure on you. And he takes a nice swing at this ball, tailing away from him.
Coming into the College World Series in postseason play, he was 20 for 33, 8 home runs, 5 doubles, and 19 RBIs in 8 games. And they hit him.
And that might be a good time to hit a guy. Not that you want to hit him on purpose, but two outs, and he looks like he's starting to get a little bit of a groove. And you mentioned the numbers, Mike. That just doesn't disappear in one night.
We have had 14 men hit in this College World Series so far. The record for an entire series is 24.
So much for people saying they don't pitch inside in the college game.
Took something off, and McCullough swung over the top. Jay struck out and grounded to short. Matthews with 10 steals this year. Strike called. He's gone. And Kenny Baugh hits a batter and then comes right back to strike out McCullough. The end of the top of the fifth. We're still tied 1-1.
I just love spending time in the backyard.
Yeah, just us and the dang bugs. Excuse me, but haven't you heard of Rooms with a View? Buy a new glass room and use it for games, exercise, or family gatherings. Payments start at $98 a month, plus order now and get free AC. For a free estimate, call Rooms with a View at 1-800-522-2171.
Houstonians have never been afraid to dream big. And where do more people dream those dreams? On a Sealy mattress from Fingers. Today we're celebrating our anniversary with a Sealy sale so big it took 72 years in the making. Every Sealy Posturepedic, every Crown Jewel, every Sealy mattress is on sale. And you don't pay a dime till January 2000. Best of all, you can win the Sport Expedition from Lawrence Marshall. The Sealy sale of your dreams is at your fingers.
It's a baseball player's dream. The IMAX Theater and the Henry Dorley Zoo in the shadow of the stadium. A beautiful place. It's a nice city. Ever get a chance to come to Omaha, especially if you get a chance to come during the College World Series, you will not regret it.
Great food, great restaurants.
And we've been blessed with the weather, too. It looked like on Wednesday and Thursday we were going to have to build an ark. But things have cleared out pretty well. It's been a beautiful day today, and we expect the next two or three to be just as nice. Go to the Rice half of the fifth inning, and Matt Fox, the number nine man in the order, will lead it off. He struck out his first time up, is 0 for 4 here in Omaha, looking for his first College World Series hit. And a great number nine hitter for this team. 31 RBIs. Swung an outside pitch there, 0-2.
I talked about the groin pains of Kenny Bob being in and out of the struggles here that he's been through. As you look at Zane Curry getting some wax on his thumb to tighten up that nail from coming off. But Matt Fox has been through it too. He's going to take home some learning lessons also.
Catchers just get beaten to a pulp.
That's one position I don't think I would ever want to play.
You got to want to be in the game really badly. Chopped on the ground toward Gasparino, tries to short hop it and can't come up with it.
Sometimes when the ball leaves the bat, you just know he's in trouble. Meaning he being whoever the ball's hit at, not necessarily Gasparino, because he had no chance at that ball as soon as it was hit. It's going to be an in-between hop. Now watch, just it hits hard on the dirt and dirt to dirt, and that ball is bouncing up like a super ball. That's a tough play to make. Takes a lot of practice. But if you can get off to the side of that ball right there and kind of scoop it coming through, that gives you a better angle to see the ball. When you're coming straight on, it's tough to read that hop.
Back to the top of the order after the error on Gasparino. Fake the sacrifice, and then the throw down to first is not in time. It's an excellent point about getting to the side of it, because when it comes up that high, your eyes just can't follow it all the way up in your glove.
Absolutely. If you get up to the side, then you can look it in, because you can move your head and rotate it, but when your head is straight on, it can either go up or down. It doesn't go to the side.
Charles Williams at the top of the order. Rice here in the home half of the fifth inning. And Wayne Graham is talking to Charles Williams.
Well, Mike, we're moving into that point.
May have missed a sign, do you think?
Yeah, it seems like it. Well, we're moving to that point of the game where, look, we got to execute. And coach is going to take over. There's not going to be, let me give a sign, hopefully he'll get it. I'm going to make sure that everybody knows what's going on. Because if you don't, the season is over.
It's got to be frustrating for Wayne Graham. I mean, I'm sure they've used the same sign since they started. And when somebody misses one, it just drives you crazy. 0-2 to Williams. Look how far outside they're set up.
a waste pitch right there. The other thing that comes into mind when you're thinking about the Rice players, you know, Stanford had eight guys take finals here at the College World Series. Priorities are education, not necessarily baseball. And Rice, one of those higher learning institutions, too. You kind of zone out sometimes when you're thinking about studying all the time.
Chase, the scoreboard, it's 1-1 instead of 0-2. So now it's 2-1. They will appeal down to first, but nothing doing. So 2-1, and the bunt is still in order for Williams. And now he's going to take a nice long look at Wayne Graham and make sure he gets this one.
That's right. Well, I wouldn't be surprised to see a hit and run here. You got your leadoff hitter on. Matt Fox runs pretty good. Nope.
Uh-oh. Hit in the air to straightaway center field. Rhodes off the top of the wall. And they're going to hold him at third. It's a run-scoring triple. That ball just carried and carried and carried into the wind.
Well, you wonder why this young man went in the fifth round. He just showed you why. He's a switch hitter with some serious juice. He's been struggling. He just tried to put the bat on the ball. What a pretty swing and follow through. Charles Williams with some extension off the top of the wall. Just missed a two-run homer.
I'll tell you, he crushed that. That wind's got to be 20 miles an hour.
Whew. That was some bat speed right there.
Toby Rhodes kept going back. And the ball just continued to carry over his head. You're right, that missed by a foot of being out of here.
Impressive swing.
In this College World Series, there has not been a home run to center field. 3 to left and 13 to right. That has been the prevailing wind since we started on Friday. And normally, I just think LSU probably hit 15 to left center one year by themselves.
Mm-hmm.
The wind is normally blowing out to left center field, and it is a launching pad when it does.
But it's made for better baseball.
It has. I'd like to see it blow straight in every day. 0-2 to Smith. Got him on a high fastball.
Ryan Buddy keeps you on your toes back there because he is coming up ready to fire at any base. We saw him throw the first. Saw the pump fake earlier, throwing the third. He gets a strikeout right there, and he's coming up and got Williams running back to third base. So he puts a little bit of fear in the base runner.
The eighth strikeout for Matt Smith. Now, you better not wander too far away, as Buddy has a gun. One out, and the infield playing back.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised at that, too, Mike. It's a 2-1 game, and there's not been a whole lot of offense. It's been teeter-tottering back and forth. You got to try to cut that run off because two run down is going to be tough to pick up.
Inside for a ball to Damon Thames. Reached on an error and singled. Bluda is warming up in the bullpen for Oklahoma State. One out. Runner at third. In the dirt. Nice block by Buddy. The book on him, he doesn't block the ball well, but he saved a run there.
He sure did. Now you got Thames in a 3-1 count. Great move by Buddy. Just keeping the ball in front of you. Square it up and keep in front. You know where the runner is at third base. Get a look at the bullpen there.
Bluda trying to get ready here in the fifth. Thames has had two hits in the College World Series. Another one here would deliver a run, and he tries to lay it down. Oh, what a nice thought. He gets a run home. If that's fair, the run scores no matter what, and he might have a base hit as well.
And especially on a count there where you're thinking he's going to swing away now, just a great idea. And Mike, once again, we talked about bunting. You want to bunt fair or foul right there? Foul ball. I love this kid. He's some kind of player. You can see the intelligence. But we saw him make the plays at short. The other thing I like about him, no batting gloves. How often do you see that?
That's right. And now with two strikes, the infield comes in. chop foul outside of third.
He's a throwback. Not too many guys go up there with the non-batting glove grip. I never did. And particularly with the aluminum bat, it gives you a little more of a ring than necessarily a wooden bat. You get that good feel, but with an aluminum, it gives you even more of a sting to your hands. You got to have some pretty good hands to hit with an aluminum bat.
2-2 to Thames. High fastball struck him out. Great back-to-back strikeouts for Smith. 9 for the game, and Thames chased one up around the bill of his cap.
It's a great pitch by Smith. He takes him to a whole nether plane. Now, everything he had done was working down in the zone that Thames had seen, and he goes up to a whole nether plane. And again, Mike, that pitch up in the eyes that looks so appetizing to you.
You see the elbows in tight. You just can't extend your arms. You're just hacking at it.
Smith's showing some good endurance. That was his 100th pitch of the night, and he had a little juice on that ball.
That'll leave it up to Will Ford. He has fanned twice in this game.
Uh-oh.
Here's a bunt down the third baseline, and a good one. The pitcher can't come up with it. Smith had one chance, bobbled the ball. It looked like he went for it with his glove. And it's stuck in the grass.
Yeah, he sure did, Mike. He went after that with the glove instead of the bare hand. Now watch Smith, how he falls off. He falls off to go get it. The ball was bunted hard, but in that situation, you got to go ahead and just try to bare hand because you got a runner flying down the line. But the element of surprise, when you catch somebody off guard, you force them to make a mistake, and right there, he forced him to have to go with a glove instead of the bare hand because he's not thinking about that situation.
So the cleanup man who had homered in the first game bunts home a run. This one lofted high in the air to right. Matthews is there, makes the catch, but the damage is done. Rice pushes across another run, and the Owls lead in this elimination game 3-1.
Oh, hi there. Michael Landrum for Timex, here with the Timex Turn and Pull Alarm Watch. Just turn the ring either way and pull the crown to set it for short or long-term reminders. Let's try setting it for 11 minutes. Just turn the ring and pull the crown. Tune in next week when we discuss walking.
The Timex Turn and Pull Alarm Watch. So simple, we should have thought of it years ago.
This isn't about making medicine. It's about making money. Janus analyzed this pharmaceuticals company within an inch of its life. Diagnosis, a good investment, if their new drug was approved. So Janus had an independent lab double-check the company's research and confirm the drug's potential. Janus invested, the drug was approved, and Janus owned a little piece of every pill. Feeling financially healthy? Get there. Janus Mutual Funds.
If you're shopping for a new cellular phone, Circuit City can clear the air. We have the top brands you know, and our knowledgeable sales counselors will help you find the rate plan that's best for you. Right now at Circuit City, get a $30 bonus rebate on select wireless phones, like this tiny Motorola StarTAC cellular phone with 20-number memory and up to 60-minute talk time. Now just one penny. For low prices and knowledgeable advice, stop by Circuit City today.
It's a baseball player's dream. That's Omaha.
One ball player I'll never forget was Ron Vini in 1967. He was Arizona State's catcher, and he became a fan favorite from day one when they stepped on the diamond that day. They nicknamed him Pigpen. He was full of dirt after the first inning, and he went on to lead Arizona State to the championship that year. And batted 400 and was also named the MVP that year.
For 50 years, they've been playing it here in Omaha.
It was Omaha native Ty Borman who graduated from high school here in 1965 and just so happened to be headed for college at Arizona State. Little did he know the Sun Devils were headed to the College World Series that year, and they would win the title in 1967. Some great memories for these folks.
Oh, yeah. Very, very impressive list of all-time greats on this. This came through this tourname, too.
Yes, sir.
The all-tourney team, that's what I'm looking for.
Becerra will lead it off here in the Oklahoma State sixth inning. He has a double and a walk so far, his only appearances in the College World Series, and hitting 361. Tom Holliday said he had a good feeling about this young man playing today, and it's panned out for him. Bottom third of the order schedule. Tom Holliday is one of those guys, you know, who had to follow someone with incredible success in Gary Ward, a man he was an assistant coach for a long time. And there was a lot of media pressure on him this year because he had not made the College World Series for 2 years, but he's got this team back, and he'll bring him here a lot, I guarantee you that.
Well, it's really interesting that they would jump on him. If you think about it, this man has been an assistant or in the program at Oklahoma State for 20 years now.
Right.
He recruited me when I was in high school. He did all the recruiting for Oklahoma State. So there's always somebody behind the head man who gets the job done. All the great players they've had come through this program, that man's the responsible one for getting them there.
Absolutely. Won at least 40 games each of his first 3 years, but this is his first trip to Omaha as the head man. A diving stop by Smith and throws him out. On the button from Becerra, and Smith laid out and stopped it.
And Smith got up quick and made the throw. You don't wait for the umpire to tell you if it's an out or not. Gets a great jump. This ball is laced, but he gets a great jump, dives, gets up. Doesn't waste any time. He goes ahead and throws it. Maybe I trapped it, maybe I didn't, but I'm going to get the out. Seen some nice efforts. That's a great play. And positioning.
And it's really demoralizing to an offense when you're trying to come back. How big a play was that? Here's a ringing single to right field. Could have been runners at first and second or first and third with nobody out.
Now, if I'm Wayne Graham, I'm looking at signs, the fact that Kenny Ball, even though he was in trouble early in the game, they never pulled the ball hard on him. They didn't hit him hard. They hit his changeup, they pulled. Now, that's two batters in a row that jumped on that fastball. So that's telling me he's losing velocity. That was his 104th pitch of the game. Now it's when I get my bullpen up.
Ryan Buddy stands in. Man on, a man out here in the sixth. Of course, as a head coach in the loser's bracket, you're sort of between a rock and a hard place. You want to get as much as you can out of a starter because you don't want to eat up your pitching staff, but you got to balance that between winning this game and staying in the tournament. Fastball hit hard to center field, and nice running catch by Justin Gray.
That's three bullets that have been hit off him this inning.
But still only one man on, and now two out. Well, he has been tremendous at getting out of jams so far. As we said, two bases loaded situations in a row at the start of the ball game. Nobody out in the first, nobody out in the second, no one scored. And the only run that scored was on a bad hop single over the head of the second baseman, Brett Smith.
I see him again. I'm just going to go up to him and say, "Hey, Harry, how you doing?" He's probably going to go, "What are you talking about?" I'm going to say, "Harry Houdini."
Then you'll have to tell him who Harry Houdini was.
Exactly.
Another breaking pitch from Kenny Ball right there. 0-2 to Gautreau.
Well, you saw Rhodes right there, Mike, out of the corner of your eye, probably trying to break the second. He didn't get a good read. But the other thing that does that, alerts the whole team, the other team, that you might be possibly running.
Came in on him with a fastball. That's fouled off. Marty Aronoff, our statistician, points out the difference in tonight's game so far. Tremendous infield play for Rice. They've turned a couple of double plays. And excellent individual efforts by Thames, who saved a run, and Smith, who saved a base hit, while Oklahoma State has had a couple of throwing errors that led to a pair of unearned runs. And this one skips over the shoulder of Curry. And it's going to get Toby Rhodes easily into second base.
Well, Toby Rhodes tipped that off two pitches earlier. I was trying to tell them he's getting ready to run. You had an 0-2 count, and they bounced a breaking ball instead of setting up and maybe throwing a pitch out or a fastball. You can waste a pitch in that situation when you're up 0-2.
So Rhodes is perfect stealing bases this year, 6-for-6.
And that's a great call by Holiday. Hey, I'm going to go ahead and send my number 9 hitter down there, and maybe he can steal this base. And if he doesn't, or send Rhodes if he steals the base. If not, I got a guy that I know can lead off for me to start next inning.
Exactly. Trying to claw his way back in this game in the sixth. We are in the top of the sixth, an elimination game, Elimination Sunday, here at the College World Series from Omaha. And it is a 3-1 Rice lead over Oklahoma State. Back up the middle, behind the back, Thames got him. Another sparkling play from shortstop Damon Thames. That ends the threat in the sixth. Oklahoma State now 3-for-19 with runners in scoring.
With Matchlight, you get the best charcoal, Kingsford, with just the right amount of lighter fluid already added. That's why there's only one match for Matchlight. Matchlight from Kingsford.
Select road. Validating tires.
What kind of road can you drive on with BF Goodrich tires? Any road you choose. BF Goodrich tires take control. The new all-terrain TAKO. Go anywhere, anytime. See your BF Goodrich tire retailer today.
Do some of America's most successful people get their start? Did somebody say McDonald's?
Beautiful Rosenblatt Stadium here in Omaha, Nebraska, where we have set another record, more than 24,000 on hand here tonight for this elimination game. Just shows you the love that these people have for baseball. Here are two teams that drop their opening game. The loser goes home, the winner hanging on by its fingernails to play again. And we have nearly 25,000 folks who have come out to see it.
Set a record on a losing bracket game.
That's right.
Unbelievable.
Jason Gray will lead it off. He's 1-for-2, has his season's average up to .329, and is hitting 2-for-5 here in the College World Series. He'll lead it off against Matt Smith. Takes a fastball to waste on the corner. Smith and Ball hooked up in a good one.
I was just thinking, Mike, you know, Smith is down 3-1, but he has really pitched a great game. Been around the plate, got a nice little sharp slider, a hard overpowering fastball.
That one's way outside, 2-1. We have not had many close games so far.
No. And we were hoping we'd have a good ball game. We got one.
Whoa, Smith has been overpowering at times with 8 strikeouts. He's also given up 7 hits.
The home plate umpire, you know, we've been on these guys a lot, but he has been so consistent tonight.
This one is pulled, knocked down by the second baseman. Lucas got up and threw him out. Nice play by Lucas. That ball looked like it knuckled on him a little bit, or he misjudged the speed of it.
Yeah, I think you might be right calling the knuckle, but what he does do is he circles this ball and keeps it in front of him. See him knock it down and keep it in front of him instead of knocking it away from him. It allows him to make the throw. He circles and now he knocks it back in front of him instead of behind him. And all he's got to do is crawl. He's got a strong arm. He's made three or four nice plays already in the series. And that's just another one to add to his list.
Baker takes one in at the knees. And there is the Oklahoma State bullpen in action again. Bluda and Pearson heating up. Baker, one for two tonight.
And speaking of bullpens, if I'm Rice, I get my bullpen up right now.
But we saw in the earlier game, Miami went to its closer very early in the game in the seventh inning because it was a situation, if I recall, guys on first and second, game was in balance, and they went to the closer, and it worked out beautifully.
You're absolutely right. Sometimes there's a situation in the game that dictates now it's time to close it. This young man right here, he's pitched a great game, but he's running out of gas. They've hit the ball hard last inning. Fortunately, it was at people, and he was able to wiggle out of it again. And Kenny Ball has really pitched a courageous game, and he's been around the plate. That always helps when you're around the plate.
You need three guys to drag him off the mound.
Oh, yeah, he's not going to want to come out.
Jacob Baker with a 2-2 count, the spiritual leader of this ball club. Late in the season when most people's bat speed goes down, his has been going up. Hit that one a long way, but foul down the right field line. One out, nobody on here in the Rice half of the sixth inning. The Owls up 3-1 over the Cowboys. It's an elimination game here in the series. Fastball right back through the box. Gasparino behind second. Nice play and threw him out. Well, Gasparino had two errors in this ball game. Comes up with a nice play behind the bag.
Well, and that's what Coach Holliday was talking about. This guy's got tremendous upskill. Now he's got 35 errors, but watch out. He stays with this ball the whole way, and the strong arm, knowing where he's at. That's why over the course of 500 or 600 or 700 minor league games, you get more situations to handle the ball. He feels that this young man's going to be sometime a big league shortstop.
Zane Curry, the catcher, with two out and nobody on. Sometimes you also see guys who are gifted physically make the hard plays. They mess up on some of the easy plays.
Yeah.
It's a matter of concentration.
Absolutely. And that's just a matter, again, of being out there and knowing to anticipate the ball, have it be hit to me all the time. The other thing you have to learn, and a lot of young players have a tough time learning, is you can't take your offense to defense. When you're able to separate that, you might strike out, line out, or like he did last inning, and you take it to defense with you, and you end up making an error.
Swing and a miss, 1-2.
Some of the dudes of the 90s.
Harold, that'll look good on you.
Harold Rodman. Don't think that would work.
Just missed with a fastball.
I'm telling you, the man behind the plate has been consistent with his zone all night. It makes it better for everybody, the pitchers, the hitters, us up here in the booth.
I think Rich Fetchett has called a fine game.
Yes, he has.
He has a small but very consistent strike zone. And that's right down there at the knees over the heart of the plate. Struck him out, 10 for Matt Smith. End of six, 3-1, Owls.
Looking for a fabulous seafood restaurant? I'm Chris King, inviting you out to Kingfish Market on Richmond Avenue. I've got the best seafood Houston has to offer. I'm talking about mouth-watering, great-tasting, lip-smacking good food. For all you lobster lovers, every Wednesday, it's all-you-can-eat live Maine lobster. For great drinks and 25-cent oysters, come to the Happiest Happy Hour every weekday from 3 to 7. Kingfish Market on Richmond Avenue, where fish is our middle name.
I just love spending time in the backyard.
Yeah, just us and the dang bugs.
Excuse me, but haven't you heard of Rooms with a View? Buy a new glass room and use it for games, exercise, or family gatherings. Payments start at $98 a month, plus order now and get free AC. For a free estimate, call Rooms with a View at 1-800-522-2171.
Just don't mix. Like drinking and driving.
Welcome back to Omaha. Now, Gasparino made a nice play for Oklahoma State, but this young man right here, Damian Thames, has had a tremendous night. Right here, the double play. Look at the wasted motion. That's what I like, is he doesn't take a lot of time. A half a step and the throw back to close an inning out. And then right here, the slow grounder. Now he recognizes it and has enough presence to come back in, cut the ball off, and make a throw on the run. A lot of the infielders in the College World Series here have had a tough time because the grass is high and the dirt is slow, and so you get a different read than normally would. He's picked it all up. He's been tremendous.
Try for the bunt, pop toward the second baseman. Smith with a diving catch. Seeing some leather on the infield tonight.
And that's great judgment, Mike, because if that ball bounces, the first baseman is beat to the bag, and so does the pitcher. You got to know when to dive for the ball. Look at the infielders. They're totally, it's a base hit if he lets it bounce. So you go ahead and you lay out and make the catch.
That's pretty.
It's pretty.
Lucas got it up in the air, nearly got away with it on a base hit. And Baugh has one out here in the seventh inning. And pitching to Gasparino, who is 0 for 2, and his average is down to 366. This kid can launch it. He sent one to the warning track and left, actually farther than the warning track, to the wall against a 20-mile-an-hour wind.
If he hits that same ball right now, I think it might have a chance of going out. The wind started to die down a little bit, but the ball he hit would challenge that wind right now.
2-0 to Gasparino from Baugh. And either the scoreboard is wrong, and it says 2-1. Now it's 3-1.
I was going to say, somebody's missing it. Yeah. Either we are or the hitter is.
Missed that time, ball four. So Gasparino draws his second walk off of Kenny Baugh. Sports Century's countdown of the top 50 North American athletes of the past century continues Friday night at 10:30. Number 31 is Bobby Orr, the winner of 8 Norris trophies. He redefined the role of a defenseman. Number 31, Bobby Orr, Friday night at 10:30 on ESPN. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com.
Well, Mike, right here, I don't let him face Holiday from the left side. If I'm coaching this team right here, he's had the base hit, last at bat, he just missed a fastball that he skied into, a high fly ball. The wind's blowing to right field, and he's a tremendous hitter from the left side of the plate.
Jeff Nichols and Jesse Kurtz-Nickel warming up in the bullpen. Nichols a starter, projected starter for the next game. And Kurtz-Nickel is the closer. Checking throw over to keep Gasparino close. He's stolen 27 bases this year. He can run. And Holiday, a big-time clutch hitter.
Well, I'd be surprised if they let Gasparino run right here, because you want Holiday to swing the bat as hot as he's been. Especially with Matthews struggling a little bit. You don't want to take the bat out of his hand.
Although Matthews had a couple of good cuts his last at bat before he was hit.
Yeah, but they got the left-hander warming up down there who I'm sure Matthews would end up seeing.
One swing can tie it up a little high to Holiday, 1-0. His teammates hoping he can come through. And this is the reason he passed on the draft last year and came back this season to lead his team to the College World Series. And as Mike Martin of Florida State says, he doesn't want 0-2 in a barbecue. He want to win one out here.
Got that right.
Check the swing.
Well, that was a good pitch right there. Threw him a changeup. Got him out front, but Holiday's keyholing on a fastball right now. He's looking for something to juice. He's got one thing on his mind. He wants to get one up.
A change has been a very effective pitch for Kenny Ball tonight. One and one to Holiday. Fastball chopped down to first. Baker thinks better of the throw to second and gets the sure out at first. Gasparino goes down to second. And now the All-American Lamont Matthews.
So what do you do, Mike? You go get the lefty to face Matthews, or you leave him in to face Matthews?
I leave him in to face Matthews, and I really don't care whether I walk him or not. Even though it puts a tying run on base, I don't care.
You're right. You make him have to chase a pitch right here. He's hitting 388 for some reason. We'll have to see what he can do.
Well, 30 dingers and 105 RBIs.
I'm not pitching to him. I'm going to get the lefty.
Fastball right down the middle, popped up on the infield.
You know who's taking charge of that one.
Thames makes the catch, so they pitched to him, and he got something he could hit, maybe even something he could drive, and he popped it straight up in the air. That's the end of the seventh. 3-1 Rice.
Call it a bonanza, an extravaganza. It's how you save on tires. Now at Pep Boys, all 35,000-mile tires are four for only $99, and all 70,000-mile tires, four for $169.
Pep Boys. Cars like us.
People love us.
Sometimes you have to make a choice. You can throw in the towel, or you can use it to wipe the sweat off your face.
Yeah, they stink. But with the new Sony Digital 8 Handycam, they've never looked better. With three times the color information and a sharper picture than VHS-C, what you live is what you get. 8mm has gone digital.
The galaxy's most legendary heroes. Fearsome villains. And coolest vehicles.
Now available to take home and play with at Taco Bell, KFC, and Pizza Hut. Right now, at participating Pizza Hut locations, you can get one of these Pizza Place Love Star Wars Episode 1 toys. 99 cents each with every pizza purchase. You can get them at Pizza Hut or even get them delivered.
Those of you that
welcome back to Omaha. Mr. Reynolds would like a couple of barbecue platters, please.
Thank you. What a joke. Send it up right now.
Send them on up.
Well, Mike, you get a look at this pitch you're talking about. It's right here, right down the middle. And I mean, Lamont Matthews missed it. You know, one thing that I'm learning is these coaches know these kids a lot better than I do, because he'd have been out of the game an inning ago if I was coaching. But boy, he missed a good one, didn't he?
Well, that's also the beauty of baseball. It's when do you take a guy out? Who do you pitch to? How do you pitch to him?
That's right. That's why it's the best sport around.
Second guesser's heaven. Matt Fox, the number nine hitter, will lead it off against Matt Smith, who has been overpowering at times, but trails 3-1. Boy, Smith has absolutely nothing to be ashamed of the way he's pitched tonight. He's kept his ball club in it. Usually you hold the other team to three runs in this ballpark with aluminum bats. You've done your job. He's given up only one earned run. Thrown 105 pitches and struck out 10. Yeah. You can't ask much more of a guy, can you?
Mm-mm, not at all. Heck of a game.
Fox is 0 for 2, struck out, reached on the shortstop's error. Down and in. 2-2. Rice would love to dump a couple more runs on Tom Holliday and give Mr. Baugh a little more breathing room. Smoke to left, and it drops in front of Gautreaux. So Fox, the number nine man, leads it off with a base hit here in the Rice seventh. Let's go to Dave Ryan. Dave?
Well, Mike, Rice head coach Wayne Graham is very concerned about the health of his close friend, Houston Astros manager Larry Durker, who collapsed with a seizure today with his Astros in Houston. He is in stable condition right now in a Houston hospital, thankfully, as we've been updating it tonight on the bottom line here on ESPN2. Graham got to know Durker when Wayne was batting practice pitcher for the Astros from 1975 through 86, and he tells me Larry Durker is one of the most gracious people he's ever known in baseball, a person who loves every fabric of the game. By the way, guys, a couple of Rice players told me before the ball game tonight they know Larry Durker as well, and they like to pass on their best wishes to Larry Durker for a quick recovery.
All right, Dave, thanks very much, and certainly our best wishes go along to Larry as well for a rapid recovery and a return to the Astros. You can't have enough class acts. You know?
He's a dynamite man, and he's been around the game a lot, and when you're around baseball as long as he is, you have so many friends.
A lot of people, or enemies. but he's got friends.
He's got a lot of friends, and there's a lot of people that are really wishing him well tonight.
Charles Williams crushed one off the center field wall his last time up. Looked like he wanted to bunt there. The sacrifice and Holliday all over him in at third base. Well, it's another reason not to play third. What if that guy swings away?
And he might swing away right here at 2-0 now.
I mean, you're staring down a gun barrel. Squares around again, pulls the bat back, and takes a called strike.
I always thought 2-0 was the toughest pitch to bunt, because in the back of your mind, you're going, why am I bunting 2-0? And you don't think about the bunt. Now you take a strike 2-0, 2-1, you go ahead and you put it down because, okay, now he should be giving me the bunt.
You guys are never happy, are you? You want a room service fastball, and you don't want to bunt it. That one's high. Harold, you have to think of the team.
Yeah. That's why it's called sacrifice, right?
That's right. That's exactly right. That's but exactly
now, 3-1, you're thinking, I want to juice one again. I'm not bunting 3-1.
Runner at first. Nobody out in a 3-1 count to Charles Williams. MVP of the all-WAC tournament. Made the all-regional team. Rips it past the diving Lucas at second base. Is on his way to third. Well, he got his wish.
He got his wish, and he put a nice swing on that ball, too. Stayed with it, stayed through it. And he hit it to the right side, which allowed Fox to go ahead and go to third base. Here's a fastball. This ball is blistered because we have seen what Kevin Lucas can do with that leather. You got to hit it awful hard to get it by him, but what a pretty swing, inside out. You know, he reminds me of Phil Bradley. I played with in Seattle a long time, quarterback at Missouri.
The beautiful vagaries of this game of baseball. You try to sacrifice, you don't get it done, so the guy hits a ringing single up the middle, and instead of a runner at second with one out, you got first and third with nobody out.
Yeah, and now your pitcher is about ready to come out of the game because you put him on the ropes again with no outs.
The best extreme athletes in the world will invade San Francisco for the fifth annual Summer X Games. Events include sky surfing, street luge, skateboarding, downhill inline racing. Check it all out on ESPN, ESPN2, and ABC from June 27th until July 5th. And for more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com. Extreme sports for me these days is softball or beanbag.
Beanbag.
Brett Smith at the plate. Runner in scoring position, and he delivers with a gap shot into left center. This one will roll all the way to the wall. It's going to get two runs home. Brett Smith with a stand-up double. Five 5-1 Rice. That'll make that broken nose feel better.
Boy, you're not kidding. And wow, Mike, you were talking about they go from a bunt, sacrifice, moving the runner over to first and third, and the next pitch is a gapper. He jumps on a fastball and drives it into the gap, and Charles Williams reads the outfielders, and he is off and running, and they're not going to cut him down at the plate. His two at-bats, he started off the series struggling. He and Matt Fox both, they started off the series struggling. Fox with the three errors. Williams with the no hits. He's got two big hits now. Fox has made another nice play, swinging the bat. Things have turned around for the Rice Owls.
And Smith will come out of the ballgame in favor of Rusty Rushing, the closer. Smith goes 6-plus, gives 5 runs, 3 Lemurns, struck out 10. Back in a moment.
Before it cracks, before it peels, before it stains, before it mildews, always use Zinsser first to prevent trouble before it has a chance to start. Zinsser primers, finishes, wall covering products, and mildew proof paints. So never ever start without Zinsser first.
America Online 4.0, the easiest just got easier.
AOL is easy.
If you have a phone line, you can be online.
AOL is the internet.
New York Times, Rolling Stone.
We've spent over $1 billion to create the world's largest high-speed network. Now with 56K, connections are faster than ever.
That fast.
You've got mail.
I've got mail.
Instant messages.
I love the buddy list.
All my friends are on it.
24-hour customer service.
AOL has got it all.
So easy, my dad can use it.
America Online, so easy to use, no wonder it's number one.
Welcome to Count Flight 101. To master hang time, you gotta make the air your friend. All right?
Yeah.
Let's go, keep up. What you waiting on?
Jump out there and shake hands with the alley-oop. Let's go, let's go. Fly to that basket.
He's worried about the landing. Gotta worry about the shot.
Jump up, let out. Don't tell me I gotta bring the shot clock out now. Come on.
Oh, flagrant foul on age 2-0.
Come on, man. I wanna see more alley. Let's oops.
Here's the line on Matt Smith. He threw 129 pitches, gave up 10 hits, struck out 10. 3 of the 5 runs were earned, and the new pitcher is Rusty Rushing, their closer, who in postseason, there are his entire season numbers. In postseason, 3-0 with an ERA under 1.3. Sacrificed bunt will work and get the runner over to third. Nice job by Damon Thames to lay it down.
Well, you put it down right where you want to in this situation with the runner on second base. You know the first baseman's not holding anybody, and he's going to crash on you. So you go up there, and you set your angle to drop it down to third. He did a nice job moving the man up.
So now Will Ford has a man at third with one out and a chance to extend the lead against Rushing. Got a good slider, a curve, and a fastball up to 93 miles an hour, and they're not going to bother with Ford. They're going to put him on.
Well, it's interesting watching pitchers throw, trying to intentionally walk. Some guys lob the ball, some guys throw a bullet like Rushing's doing here, but most pitchers have a tough time with the pitch out.
A lot of guys get precariously close to the strike zone.
And that's why I like it in college and pro ball. They make you throw the 4 pitches. In high school, they just point to the base and send the kid down there. But I like him having to throw the 4 pitches. You never know what's going to happen.
Nice move there by Coach Holliday to set up the double play. He's got to get out of this inning with no more damage. And they'll pitch to Justin Berg.
And it'll be interesting how bad does Wayne Graham want that run over there. Oh, they had him.
And that play works about once every 6 or 7 years. And when it does, it's unbelievable.
Sometimes you use that play just to see what the base runner is going to do. You don't even do it with the intent of picking him off. You want to see if he's leaning, if he's going to tip off a bunt or a steal or a squeeze or whatever.
Berg hits it in the air to right field. Matthews. with the catch. Here's the tag, the throw home. Matthews tries to airmail one all the way in, and it's offline. 6-1 Rice. Bird gets the job done with a sack fly.
Wow, pretty impressive throw, though. With a strong throw just off the mark, but Rice with the execution. They've executed all day long. They've played great defense. They've hit and run. They've bunted. They've done the little thing.
This is the Rice team that people saw all year long that ended up being ranked number one in the ESPN USA Today poll coming into the College World Series. This is the way they play. That's why they had a 58-14 record and 10 players drafted off this club. Runner goes.
Does he have a gun?
Buddy has an arm. He reminds you of Charles Johnson, who starred here for Miami in the College World Series. He can get it down there. But another run for Rice. It's 6-1.
It's back.
Cannon Day at the Houston Camera Exchange.
Saturday, June 19th. Cannon technicians will clean and check your Cannon camera absolutely no charge.
Plus, register to win a free advanced photo system help and a free WP1 waterproof camera.
And every new Cannon SLR sold gets a free $50 tripod.
Plus, you can cash in with Cannon with up to $300 or more cash back.
Saturday, June 19th.
It's Cannon Day.
The Houston Camera Exchange. 5900 Richmond at Fountain View.
Some guys look so good in a Suit Mart designer suit, they never want to take it off. And right now, we've got thousands of two-fur specials.
Thousands of imported sport coats.
Get two for $100.
Thousands of imported suits.
Get two for $150.
Because if you want two-furs,
then you want Suit Mart.
Suit Mart open every day through Father's Day.
Tradition reborn on ESPN2, Friday Night Fights. This week, Robert West takes on Tom Noonan. Then, Hector Macho Camacho battles B.J. Goosen in a 10-round junior middleweight bout. Friday Night Fights, Friday at 10:30 on ESPN2.
6-1, Rice with the lead over Oklahoma State in an elimination game. Earlier today in the winner's bracket, Miami and Alabama met, and Kevin Brown broke open a scoreless tie when he hit the foul pole and left for a home run. Starter Alex Santos was strong, including striking out the side in the sixth. Then the Canes broke open a tight game. Back-to-back bases-loaded walks in the seventh did the damage. And then closer Michael New entered in the seventh and shut the door. Miami wins it, a final of 8 runs on 14 hits and 2 errors. Santos got his 12th win of the year. Brown 2-for-4 with a home run, and Lolly Esquivel went 3-for-4 in the ballgame. Miami the first team to 2-0. McCullough leads off the inning with a fly ball to left. Gautreau out there makes the catch.
Well, Mike, at the beginning of the show, at the beginning of the game, I told you that this young man was going to remind you a lot of Jason Young from Stanford. And Jason Young had his little up and down turbulent times. We even talked about that a little bit last night. And here's Kenny Ball right here in the eighth inning now. When I thought he'd be out of here about the fifth, the way he started, he was on his way out of here in the first.
Yes, he was. They were warming up in the first and second inning when he loaded the bases with nobody out. Both the first and the second got out of it without any damage. He has had 3 complete games this year. He's in the low 120s in the pitch count right now, 123. Like they say, you can rest when the season's over. This is the World Series.
Yeah.
And he's only 5 outs away from keeping his team in the College World Series and sending Oklahoma State home. Fastball.
Well, I think about Oklahoma State's 2 games here. They have to be the most frustrating games of the year for them because they had the bases loaded both games in the first inning and weren't able to capitalize, and their offense sputtered ever since.
You only get so many chances, and if you don't capitalize on some of those, you're not going to get any more. The other guys are on scholarship too. Swing and a miss, and Becerra goes down. the fifth strikeout for Kenny Ball. More College World Series action for you tomorrow afternoon. Second round games from the second bracket. And the winners draw Florida State and Stanford on ESPN. Then on the deuce in the nightcap, Texas A&M against Cal State Fullerton. That is another elimination game. Earlier today here in bracket one, Miami went to 2-0 beating Alabama. They'll get a rest, and Alabama will take on the winner of this game on Tuesday. Two out and nobody on for Toby Rhodes. OSU down to its last four outs.
You know what's interesting, Mike, is Kenny Ball just looks stronger.
He does.
Got him a couple runs, give him some breathing room.
Toby Rhodes platooning in center field, got the start today. He's 2-for-3. Ooh. Hits this one on the button. Ford back to the track, and it's gone. Toby Rhodes with his seventh home run of the year. He's 3-for-4. The freshman gets a thrill here in Omaha.
I got a feeling he's going to get a chance to come back here. Even if they are eliminated tonight, he will be back in Omaha before his college career is over.
5'10", 154 pounds. That's his seventh home run.
Well, you were talking about McGuire-esque with his home run to bat ratio, and he got a fastball out over the plate, 2-0. It looked like a BP fastball, and he hit it like batting practice. He just drove it out.
Well, he had had six in 67 at-bats. Now he has seven in 71 at-bats. His ratio's getting better.
That's pretty impressive. Who said little guys can't hit?
This one can. Jeff Nichols will come on to try to close it out, and the big hand for Kenny Ball. We'll check on Nichols in a moment.
Either you can surrender in the face of adversity, you can dunk in its face.
Make great things happen with great white paper.
It's a great day for feeling your pride, and it's a great day for smiling inside. Yes, it's a great day, so throw your arms out wide. A great day for using great white. Oh, it's a great day for making your mark, and it's a great day for working till dark. It's a great day for getting that spark. Yes, it's a great day for using Great White.
Great White. Make great things happen.
At Circuit City, we have everything you need for your computer.
From software and hardware, printers, high-speed modems, memory, or you can design your own system.
Right now at Circuit City, save $195 on this eMachines computer with 15-inch monitor and Canon BubbleJet color printer, just $549.99 after rebates. And save $40 on a Microsoft Office 2000 standard upgrade, just $189.99 after rebate. Don't miss the savings right now at Circuit City.
He works in Washington. She works in Washington. They get together on the weekends for as little as 2.5 cents a minute. Who says people in Washington are out of touch? Call Sprint at 1-800-PIN-DROP now.
6-2 Rice, and Kenny Ball stands to get the victory in this game. It would be his 12th of the season, is against only two defeats. Threw 130 pitches, went through two outs here in the eighth inning, allowed only two runs, scattered nine hits, and struck out five.
Well, the one stat we don't see right there is his heart, Mike, how courageous he was.
Absolutely.
He really left it out on the line for him.
Nichols comes on, normally a starter. Only one other relief appearance all year long. Got a good fastball up to 90 miles an hour, a curve and a change. Breaking ball just dropped low.
Well, if Nichols can't make your rotation, think of how good Rice's pitching is, because he's got pretty good stuff.
He does indeed. Buddy takes another breaking ball high, 2-1.
It was a fastball, late-breaking slider, a fastball in the 90s like you were talking about, late-breaking slider. He's got some whip action in that arm.
3-1 now. Buddy turns on one and knocks it down into the left field stands.
This young man right here, Ryan Buddy's going to have a chance. He's a young hitter, so he's going to learn how to hit now. They started off early playing him different positions. He got back to catching, and he struggled, dropped down to 275. But you can see, Mike, he's got an idea what he's trying to do at the plate. And that just gets better with at-bats. The older he gets, the better hitter he's going to become.
And Nichols missed badly on that one and walks him. He doesn't have that much experience as a relief pitcher this year, but that's not the idea that Wayne Graham was looking for.
No, it sure wasn't, but you're going to bring your best arms tonight. You got to win tonight. He better learn how to be a relief pitcher real quick.
That's right, and they'll pitch them all if they have to and then do it again in the next game. Back to the top of the order, Carlos Gautreau, and Nichols into the dirt again, blocked by Curry. Gautreau with a couple of hits tonight, 2-for-4, and his season's average is up to .349. He's had a big College World Series with 3 hits and 7 trips. Fastball right in there.
Yeah, he's been impressive. He's been the one guy that's been real consistent in that lineup.
Nichols again bounces a breaking ball on the dirt, and Curry has to save it.
We've witnessed some great catching from all the teams. Catchers do a great job of blocking pitches. I think a lot of that has to do because they throw so many breaking pitches in the college game that you get a better feel for getting down and blocking the ball. In pro baseball, you got guys throwing mid-90s, and they're working on fastballs.
I think as a group, this is the best I've ever seen out of the 8 teams. I mean, there have been some just sensational catchers out here. But you're right, it's an excellent point. As a group, you haven't seen many guys that aren't fundamentally sound, that don't have good arms, that don't handle pitchers well. Fastball, swing and a miss, 2-2. Runner at first, 2 out, a run home on the homer from Toby Rhodes. We got to give him a nickname. It's either Bumpy, Dusty, Country. What do you like?
I like Country. I like that. Bumpy was the first one.
Bumpy?
Well, you can log in on...
That's what those go.coms are for.
Right.
3-2 to Gautreau. Fastball, tap down the third baseline, rolls foul. Oklahoma State frustrated in this series with the inability to score. They lost to Alabama 11-3, and they were really down after that game because the Crimson Tide beat them up and they squandered some scoring opportunities. They've done the same here tonight. Fastball right back through the box. Gautreau with his third hit of the night, and Buddy will race to third. The Cowboys will not go quietly.
Well, they sure won't, and they still have not run out of time. It's 2 out in the 8th. But you want to continue to work your lineup to where you get to the power guys, and maybe somebody can bop one and put you right back in it.
Let's go to Dave Ryan. Dave?
Well, Mike and Harold, until just right now, it has been very quiet here in the Oklahoma State dugout with 3 runs in the home, 7th from Rice. You can hear a pin drop down here, even after the Toby Rhodes home run and then the Ryan Buddy walk. But after that base hit, finally something got going. Until then, though, not a lot of celebration or emotion down here. They know they've got a long way to come back to try to tie this game against Rice.
All right, Dave, thanks. Lucas would bring the tying run to the plate if he can keep it going in the presence of Gasparino, who has 20 home runs, and he smoked that one. Wow. Nichols has not come out of the bullpen with his best stuff. Walked the first batter, gives up a ringing single to the second. Breaking ball and hung inside, fouled off. And if Oklahoma State loses this game, they have to only look at this stat. In the College World Series, they are a collective 3-for-20, hitting 150 with runners in scoring position. Breaking ball, checked his swing but couldn't hold it. Struck him out. Nichols out of the jam, and it's 6-2 as we go to the bottom of the eighth. Rice closing in on a victory in this elimination game.
It's back.
Cannon Day at the Houston Camera Exchange.
Saturday, June 19th. Cannon technicians will clean and check your Cannon camera. Absolutely no charge.
Plus, register to win a free advanced photo system help and a free WP1 waterproof camera.
And every new Cannon SLR sold gets a free $50 tripod.
Plus, you can cash in with Cannon with up to $300 or more cash back.
Saturday, June 19th.
It's Cannon Day.
At the Houston Camera Exchange. 5900 Richmond at Fountain View.
Some guys look so good in a Suit Mart designer suit, they never want to take it off. And right now, we've got thousands of twofer specials.
Thousands of knit polo shirts.
Get two for $20.
Thousands of imported suits.
Get two for $150.
Because if you want twofers,
then you want Suit Mart.
Suit Mart open every day through Father's Day.
Dallas has Hasek seeing stars. Who will shine on this night? Stanley Cup Finals, Stars, Sabres, Game 4, Tuesday at 8, only on ESPN.
ESPN2's presentation of the NCAA College World Series is brought to you by Great White Paper. Make great things happen. And by Circuit City. Answers in every department, low prices all over the store.
Back to College World Series in Omaha. That is Casey Dumb, the young son of Jack Dumb, the Creighton baseball coach. Out here enjoying, what else? A baseball game. It's in his blood.
He's seen so many games and he's still loving it.
Well, the more we see, the more we like it, don't we?
That's right.
Rice comes to bat in the bottom of the eighth with Gray, Baker, and Curry, the scheduled hitters. Gray 1-for-3 tonight. Their lead's been cut to 4. Rusty Rushing is now the pitcher for Oklahoma State. He came out of the bullpen in the last inning. He is their closer. Right now just trying to hold them close. Give his team a chance to come back in the ninth. Hit to deep right field. Matthews back. He can't get there. Jason Gray with his 20th home run. A shot into right field. And they get the run right back.
Well, you want to try to keep that five-run distance so a grand slam doesn't beat you. And he jumped on this fastball right here. Matthews with a great effort to almost catch this, but he gets a fastball in, and that is a pretty stroke, Mike. And this is a line drive. You can't talk about wind-aided on that one because that is a bullet. Look at the effort by Matthews. He knows where he's at. Another thing very impressive, these outfielders have done a great job of knowing where the fences are when they're going back after ball.
When it was hit, I didn't think Lamont Matthews had a chance to get anywhere near it, but he got right back there on the wall, went halfway up, and nearly had a shot at it. Now Jacob Baker against Rushing. Matthews certainly has been frustrated with the bat in this series, but he'll make some noise at the next level.
And you can see the athletic ability just on that line drive right there, twisting behind him. He was able to turn and get back on his horse and in two steps at top speed and ready to climb a wall.
He practices crashing into walls and catching baseballs. That's how dedicated this young man is to the game and to improving. And you just have to feel for him the struggle he's had with the bat because he is a brilliant hitter. Wrapped on the ground to second. Lucas will throw him out. One gone here in the home half of the eighth. The best female soccer players in the world come to America this summer for the 1999 World's Cup. the top 16 countries in the world competing, including defending Women's World Cup champion Norway. Team USA will play Denmark Saturday at 3 o'clock Eastern on ABC. You can watch all the action on ABC, ESPN, and ESPN2. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com. One out, a run in on the solo homer. We're in the bottom of the eighth, 7-2, the Rice Owls over the Cowboys of Oklahoma State. And this is Zane Curry, the catcher.
He deserves a little ice.
Pitched a beautiful game tonight. Ripped into right field. Curry just hit a screamer. Matthews over quickly and comes up with it. Zane Curry has two hits tonight. And the 12th for Rice on the evening.
Well, it looks like Rice is really relaxed, and they're going up there getting good pitches to hit now. Seven runs to do that.
They looked for all the world like they were going to win their opening round game against Miami. They appeared to be in control of it. But credit to the Hurricanes, they battled back. This one's fouled back out of play by Matt Fox, who singled his last time up.
I guess when you live in the classroom as much as these guys, you don't want to have to go back to school yet.
That's right. Of course, both of these teams have just been sensational in these situations. But one is going to have to go home after this one. Most frustrating thing about this, you can have the greatest season in the world, make the field of the College World Season, a World Series, but only one of the eight is going to go home a winner. Foul back into the right field seats.
And your bats can get cold, just like Oklahoma State's bats got cold at the wrong time. You got to be able to score runs. And we're talking about a pitcher's duel, how great this has been, but there's seven runs up on the board. You know, so somebody's got to score a lot of runs to win in this series, and you can't afford for your bats to go cold.
And Fox is down on strikes. Well, if Oklahoma State cannot come back in this ballgame, let's hope the critics are not as harsh on Tom Holliday as they have been during the season. You've got to give a guy a chance when you succeed someone who has had the kind of success that Gary Ward had in any kind of a program. And it's probably the most thankless thing in the world to take over for somebody who had that kind of success. This is only his third year as the head coach. He has them back in the College World Series. He's got a tremendous baseball background and a knowledge of the game. He will have them back here again.
Well, the other thing he's done really is put the program back on its feet. Not that it fell off its feet, but now you got a lot of kids wanting to come here because they know they have a pro staff that's going to teach them the pro game.
Tough play down the left field line, and Gasparino thought Holliday was going to take it and reached out at the last minute, couldn't stab it.
Anytime you get a ball in that area right there, the shortstop is the captain. You got the best angle, so you go ahead and call everybody off and try to take it. See, he was allowing the third baseman to go ahead and dictate that. When you have dominant personalities, and I'm sure that Josh Holliday does, being a catcher, the shortstop has still got to step up and say, this is my ball because it's my situation, and he would yield to that. But somebody's got to be the captain.
Well, you're absolutely right about the angle. I mean, Holliday's got to catch that ball blind over his shoulder.
And this is the wrong guy to give another opportunity to. We saw him blister a couple balls on the right side of the plate, and now Charles Williams is over on the left side to see what he can do over here.
Just missed outside 2-2.
That's the pitch the first game that he did not get. He was getting called out on that pitch. The worm has turned.
Waits on the slow curveball and bangs it into right field. Good hustle by Lamont Matthews to come in from right and get there as quick as he could to keep the runner at second base.
Yeah, he's been all over the field, no doubt, but nice piece of hitting by Charles Williams.
That's three hits for Williams tonight. And another two-out rally.
He's behind him.
It's already a five-run lead here in the bottom of the eighth. Rushing, trying to keep it there, but Brett Smith, who had a double in his last trip, is up.
Another switch hitter. Pretty impressive when your one and two guys are switch hitters.
What a luxury.
Oh.
Beautiful breaking ball, 0-2. Fouls this one back out of play over the roof on the left side.
You know, rushing reminds me of Jeff Brantley, his delivery. He's got the nice little short arm. He short arms the ball instead of a long arm that you see from most guys. Hides it a long time and then boom. A little sneaky fastball.
I like watching New from Miami with that that hesitation going.
Uh-huh.
That's great. Bunch of kids see that on television. You'll see that all over the country. Strike three called on the inside corner at the knees. The inning is over, but Rice gets the run back and rebuilds the lead to five. We'll go to the ninth. Last chance for the Cowboys.
Well, we had a fiscal year. It was a good year. If you look at the charts, you'll see the arrow goes up, which is good, as opposed to going down. So in conclusion, that's it.
Savan pants. Soft, comfortable, stylish. So you'll look good no matter what happens.
Make great things happen with great white paper.
It's a great day for feeling your pride, and it's a great day for smiling inside. Yes, it's a great day. So throw your arms out wide. A great day for using great white. Oh, it's a great day for making your mark, and it's a great day for working till dark. It's a great day for getting that spark. Yes, it's a great day for using great white.
Great white. Make great things happen.
This isn't about making medicine. It's about making money. Janus analyzed this pharmaceuticals company within an inch of its life. Diagnosis? A good investment, if their new drug was approved. So Janus had an independent lab double-check the company's research and confirm the drug's potential. Janus invested, the drug was approved, and Janus owned a little piece of every pill. Feeling financially healthy? Get there. Janus Mutual Funds.
Back at the College World Series, we'll go to the ninth inning. Here's the Nike storyline from Omaha. Rice with a five-run lead after eight innings. Oklahoma State has failed with runners in scoring position, only 1-for-11. Ball went 7 2/3. He stands to be the winner. Nine hits, struck out four. All four starting pitchers today went into the seventh inning, the first time it has happened in 3 years, since May 31st, 1996. Seen some good pitching performances. Last chance for Oklahoma State. The 3, 4, 5 men in their order will lead it off.
Down to having to take a strike now before you go up there and swing. Try to do anything to work a count to get back into the game.
Jeff Nichols quickly ahead 0-2.
If your pitcher's intelligent and able to throw strikes, pick up that on that real quick, boom, you're going to get ahead 1-0 in a heartbeat. 0-1 in a heartbeat.
Jesse Kurtz Nickel is warming in the Rice bullpen just in case. He is the normal closer for this ball club. Another breaking ball in the dirt, and Nichols has been plagued by that ever since he came out of the pen. He has thrown a lot of curveballs that haven't even been close.
That one there is trying to make the guy reach for a pitcher. You don't want to throw one away and strike him out and put him on first anyway.
2-2 now after he got ahead in the count quickly, 0-2. That one just tipped foul in front of Zane Curry, the catcher. Extreme bloopers coming up next. I just hope we aren't on there.
I might be. I don't know about you.
I've made some extreme bloopers. Fastball hammered past third and just foul. We have an extreme blooper right now on ESPN, a 20-1 game on Sunday Night Baseball. Ouch.
The Orioles are just thumping the Atlanta Braves all over the ballpark. Cal Ripken with a couple home runs, five RBIs early in the game.
He's made an amazing return from that bad back. Straight up in the air on the infield, Damon Thames behind the bag. One gone here in the ninth. Have to be a lot of emotions right now running through that Oklahoma State dugout as Josh Holliday comes up for what could be his last at bat in a college uniform. The coach's son, who has been the emotional leader of this ball club, led them into the College World Series. That's why he passed on the draft a year ago.
Wanted to come here and win a championship.
Takes one inside on a skip, one and one.
The beauty for Josh is that his baseball career will continue. Drafted in the 10th round by the Toronto Blue Jays, and I'm sure he'll be starting up as soon as this thing ends.
Fastball sails outside. And not only an all-star for his dad as a player, but a GTE Academic All-American with a 3.8 grade point average. Said he filled out his first scouting card at the age of three in uniform on the field at Oklahoma State. A Dodger scout had him fill out a card, and the Dodgers for years kept telling him they were the ones that had first pick. This one's popped to left. Williams makes the catch, and Holliday is gone. And Lamont Matthews with two out and nobody on, the last chance for Oklahoma State. And no matter how you feel about the outcome of this ball game, I'd like to see this kid get a hit.
I'd like to see him juice one.
This has been the closest of the six games in the College World Series, except for the Miami Rice game, which was 8-4. This is a five-run game right now. Williams fouls this one back on the screen. I mean, if you're a Rice fan, let's face it, one dinger isn't going to hurt you. If you're an Oklahoma State fan, it's going to help soothe the wounds if they don't come back. And if you're a Lamont Matthews fan, well, you want to see him do well.
Sure do.
Of course, I don't know if Rice is going to be quite that charitable.
I don't think this man right here cares what
he
doesn't want no charity here.
No. Wayne doesn't want to see a 400-foot shot here. Popped on the fist, straight back. About 15 feet away from having a souvenir. Matthews, after such a brilliant regular season and then postseason where he had been torrid, is 0-for-6 here in Omaha. Swung over the top, and that is it. Williams goes down again, and Rice has survived to play another day in the College World Series. They beat Oklahoma State 7-2. Rice, very impressive tonight, Harold.
Well, they played a tremendous fundamental game. You know, Kenny Ball was able to wiggle out of some jams, but even more impressive was their offense. They stole bases, they hit and run, they really loosened up and played quite a game for being on the up against the wall.
And defensively, very sharp, especially in the infield. Final score, Rice wins to stay alive in the College World Series, 7-2 over Oklahoma State. So here in bracket one, Miami moved to 2-0 earlier today. The Crimson Tide will play Rice after they lost to Miami. Oklahoma State, our first team to be eliminated. Bracket two continues tomorrow on ESPN. Florida State faces Stanford in the winner's draw, the nightcap on ESPN2. Texas A&M, Cal State Fullerton, another elimination game. For Harold Reynolds and Dave Ryan and our entire ESPN crew, this is Mike Patrick. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com.
South tonight. beat Oklahoma State, and then their hopes of a College World Series title continue. They lose, and their season would be over. And what do? Kenny Baugh, the starter, loads the bases with nobody out in the top of the first, but he fans two, gets a ground ball to end the threat, and take a look at the reaction of his coach, Wayne Graham, in the dugout. He has a sore back, but you'd never guess it as this guy gets out of the damage. 1-1, top of the fourth. Watch the play by right shortstop Damon Thames. That gets the final out of the inning with a runner at third base. Top of the fifth, man at first, Charles Williams, rips a shot to center, very nearly leaves a yard, but it's the go-ahead triple. And then Will Ford with a bunt that plates Williams, 3-1 Owls. They win it 7-2. They stay alive. Aggies try to do the same thing tomorrow night. The earlier game today in the winner's bracket, Miami
on Oklahoma State in an elimination game. And man, oh man, Owls pitcher Kenny Baugh had a wild start in this one. After allowing the Cowboys to load the bases in each of the first two innings, he pitched his way out of trouble both times and helped out by some great defense by his teammates. He did not allow a single run. The Owls took the first lead in the second inning. And then here in the fifth, with the score tied, Charles Williams put the Owls on top to stable the triple off the center field wall, which plated Matt Fox. In the bottom of the seventh, Brett Smith drove in a pair of runs with a double. Later on, Jason Gray later added a home run. And the Owls go on to win 7-2, so the Owls stay alive as the Cowboys are eliminated. Now, earlier Sunday in Omaha, Miami beat Alabama. Kevin Brown started the scoring with a solo homer.
You know, you go out there knowing that you got a great defense behind you. Damon and Brett made some great plays behind me. The outfielders. I mean, when you know you got a defense behind you like that, you pretty much just go after the hitters. And, most of the time, they all year they've been picking me up. So, you know, that's what they did tonight.
I think it's big to, it kind of puts a mark in that W column and just kind of say we deserve to be here. I mean, we've earned it, but if you lose four straight games, you know, people starting to give us the respect that I think we've, the past teams and this year we've earned. So getting the win under our belt, and just like this second game, we were even more relaxed, more confident, and more comfortable than we were the first game.
So again, the Rice Owls still in it. Tuesday night, they will play Alabama. Good luck, Owls. They win it tonight over Oklahoma State 7-2. There's still more to come on Sports Sunday besides the missed calls. Reason number two why the umpire might need a pair of glasses. The wacky reel is next.